The InfoWars Media Operation was the first organization, if you go back more than a decade ago, to detail the globalist plan to bring in a world financial meltdown based in and around derivatives and a coming currency war, on the backs of which they would then sell a rescue plan that would cement a global government. And that is now the point that we are reaching as a society, as a culture, as a world. Just yesterday, we re-aired a piece I did about a month and a half ago, headlined Total Emergency Alert, Elites Evacuating Western Countries. And then I went over mainstream news articles saying that. But still we hear, oh, Alex Jones is a fear porn dealer. Alex Jones is a scaremonger. You know, I wish I was, and I wish I was wrong about all this. Because when the derivatives bubble goes belly up, when the currency devaluation bubble goes belly up, when the deflationary spiral starts, sandwiched in with currency devaluation, we're going to have the perfect storm of the money being worth less and there not being jobs or an economy. And you're not supposed to be able to have that economically under free market systems, but when you have rigged systems and mega banks that charge you to keep money in the bank and charge you for transactions while they push a cashless society to force you into their system, and then they themselves get free money at zero or negative interest, but then charge us interest, that is a rigged playing field. Microcosm of that is more than 10,000 nonprofit statuses issued in the last 6.5 years by Obama to Democrats, socialist, communist, NAMBLA, you name it. In the last 3 years, one conservative group has been given a tax exemption. You say, what's it have to do with the economy? It's how everything is. LIBOR, the currency markets, the interest rates, the stock market. They're as rigged as the dirtiest Atlantic City casino. In fact, I mean this when I say it. You got better odds making money in a Las Vegas or Atlantic City casino than you've got long-term in this system. And they only gave us all this free money to get us addicted, like heroin dealers or cocaine dealers handing out free samples to 12-year-olds or 10-year-olds at the local park. Now, there's a reason crack dealers will give your 14-year-old daughter some free crack, because in a month, they're going to have her on the street in another city working for them, turning 10 tricks a day. And that's now the cycle where America is going from getting the free crack to being put out on the street. It is a pimp game, a fascinating world, to quote Idiocracy and Mike Judge. So when we return, China roils markets for second day as yuan tumbles with stocks. Gold and silver surge as dollar dumps. 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash has become even more likely. These are mainstream headlines. People are like, wait, I've heard this before somewhere. You heard it here. You think I want to go up against these people? You think I want all this to happen? I'm double down, folks. I own a house. I'm invested here. I got roots here. I'm trying to stop this from happening. I'm trying to stop this from happening. But the only way to stop it is admitting what's coming before it gets here. They don't want people to know till the hammers drop so they can come out with their fake solution and pose like they're the saviors. And to build a world government run by private corporate interests that are above the law, they've got to bring down the old system. But while they do that, they max out the credit, they run the old system in the ground, and they blame the collapse on what made the old system great, capitalism. When what we have today is engineered corporate crony fascism. Congressman Walter Jones will be joining us. He's spearheading, of course, the declassification of the 28 pages, but he's read it. So is Senator Graham, and they say it clearly shows Saudi Arabia carried out the attacks. NORAD was ordered to stand down. 9/11 was an inside job. And that ties in to U.S. ex-intelligence chief, the former head of defense intelligence, says on ISIS's rise, it was a willful Washington decision and an order that the Pentagon did not agree with. We told you this 2.5 years ago when the Pentagon said no to the air bombardment, which is very rare. They just said, we're not going to follow illegal orders. And now that's come out in released DIA reports. U.S. made willful decision to support ISIS Syria. We have the video of this coming up. What did Jeb Bush come out and do in a speech he gave that CNN aired last night? Jeb Bush blames Clinton Obama for Iraq problems. They're all in on it. So it's one hand blaming the other hand, the right hand blaming the left hand. And then he goes into how we need to take out Assad to stop ISIS. Now, I predicted this would happen. Assad's battling ISIS. The West has been funding al-Qaeda, al-Nusra slash ISIS for 5 years. They think we're so dumb, they're now saying bombard Assad and that will take out ISIS. That's like saying kill Superman and Lex Luthor will die. Or, I mean, it's saying Christ is the devil. It's saying black is white, up is down, left is right. It's just a total insult to everyone's intelligence. But when you realize the general public cannot even find the Middle East on a map in national surveys, and they think Sunni is Shiite, and they think Saddam carried out 9/11, he can get up there when we've ganged up on Assad and his people and the Christians and the non-radical Muslims for 5 years and killed 300,000 of them, and their tiny military with Russian backing has been valiantly fighting the entire Saudi Arabian jihad. And now the answer is to bomb the Syrian army. And now the airstrikes are beginning against U.S.-trained rebels, who are really ISIS. They've got the F-18 Joint Strike Fighter beginning its attacks. To fight ISIS, they're going to bomb Assad, who's fighting ISIS. That'd be like having a top general, say General Green, in the War for Independence in 1778, say, get up at a podium while George Washington's addressing troops and shoot George Washington in the back of the head and say, I did that to help the cause of liberty against the corrupt crown. I've shot George Washington in the head. That's how dumb they think we are. And you know what? We are that dumb. They put hydrofluorosilicic acid in the water that they've known for 150 years eats holes in your brain, gives you bone cancer and destroys fertility and makes you servile. They put that in the water, and they put it in the food up to 600 parts per million. 1.6 part per million will lower IQ by more than 10 points if you drink it for just a few years. That's a Harvard report. Do you know what 600 parts per million does in bread powder, the powder on bread, processed bread, powdered eggs? Do you know what 600 parts per million does? It's devastating. I remember being a kid at camp, and I'd eat powdered eggs and have to go take a nap or would throw it up. Nobody told me it had fluoride in it. I just knew I felt like I'd, you know, been run over by a truck. And it's all a big sick joke to put roach poison in your food. So of course they're selling baby parts. Of course they put roach poison in most of the processed food. But let me tell you, we're having victories. 2 years ago, the FDA, under lawsuits and their own scientists saying it's deadly, said ban fluoride as a food additive and remove it and cut it out of the water 50% as a face-saving event. So I got all this news. I got tons of news here. News stacked to the rafters, all of it over the top important, but I just go back to the basics. We're not in Kansas anymore. Truth is stranger than fiction. We told you 20 years ago they were selling baby parts, keeping babies alive, vivisecting them. Photos of Margaret Sanger addressing the Klan, her giving awards to Hitler, getting awards from Hitler. But notice that's all 20-year-old news for our audience. That's in mainstream news today. It's finally on TV news showing Margaret Sanger at Klan rallies. The point is, I use the Force 10 from Navarone allegory. That's a composite based on a true story. Just like the Patriots based on three true stories. Force 10 from Navarone's base, it didn't even say this in the movie, but I read it in the history book, is based on a true story. Where they bombed a dam in Croatia to flood the Germans and knock out a bridge, and it took about a day for the dam to finally crack and explode and collapse. In the movie, it takes like 20 minutes. And it's the same thing. We've already blown their ass. You understand that? We've already smashed the living hell out of the enemy. And that's why they got to take everything over now. It's like, I'll use more Hollywood analogies. It's like sending a Terminator back in history to take out Sarah Connor because we've already won in the future. They've got to accelerate, take over, shut everything down now because we've already smashed the living hell out of them. And excuse me getting so excited, but I'm just here to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that it's all going to come out. The white slavery kidnapping rings. High-level people in the federal government don't want to be part of this. The snuff films, the body parts, the government drug dealing, the Mexican drug cartels run by the CIA, because people in the CIA don't want to go along with it. People are sick of it all. Everything's going to come out, and there's nothing they can do from stopping it. Here's the bad news. We're going to beat them on the current trajectory we're at. So they're tripling down now in their projections, in their war games, in their actuaries, in their analyses to try to beat us in the future. And I've looked at it. I don't have all their supercomputers and the rest of it, but I've got history and the good sense God gave me, and I can sit back and look at them. I can tell you this. They're going to fail, but they may destroy the planet in the process of trying to keep control. So here's the big announcement for everybody. Get yourselves strapped in, because there's going to be big wars. There's going to be bioweapon releases. I think you're probably going to see nukes go off. They'll say they don't know who did it. It's going to get crazy. There is no doubt now we've crossed the threshold and are going into crazy town. I don't know how bad it's going to be. The faster we wake up, the more we wake up, may actually back them off. They may capitulate and just sue for peace and slow down. That's our only hope. And the reason so many of their own people are leaking info right now is they realize how evil this system is. They realize they were told a lie about globalism, that it was to bring in world peace, that it's a fraud, that it's been totally corrupted from the beginning, was a deception, and that it all will come down. Now, excuse me using some mild French here on air. I apologize. It's just so real in my gut, in my spirit, in my mind. I know that we've already placed the explosives on the dam many times. It doesn't come down overnight, and now it's starting to crack, and the enemy can look at their system and tell it's coming down. That's why they want to go ahead and bring it all down, pose as the saviors, and grab victory from the jaws of defeat. If we fail, we're going to be snatching defeat from the jaws of victory. All we got to do is spread the word. All we got to do is tell the truth. All we got to do is say we don't comply with unconstitutional garbage. All we got to do is stand strong. And this system will come down. This system will fail. It will stall out. Does it mean we'll be in some utopia? Absolutely not. Does it mean we won't have bigger problems in some areas? No, we will. But there's forces of good and evil in this world, not just the evil. And that's why everything they do is to dumb us down, because they're scared of strong men and women. They're strong of the light in our eyes, the light in our soul. They're scared of the fact that we want justice. We are outrageously horrifying to these people, and we should be. If you look at our enemies, they are pathetically weak. That's why they seek power. It's time for good men and women to stand up and say no. And when we take that first mighty step into what appears to be oblivion, that's when God will catch us. But you have to take the first step and commit and say, just like that astronaut was talking about yesterday, once you get on top of that rocket, you know there's a 1-in-50 chance it's going to blow up and kill you, but you're not afraid because you made the decision to do it. And some of us in this political system will be blown up. Some of us will be killed, destroyed, politically assassinated. But it's all part of God's greater plan. When we come back, the accelerating global meltdown now goes from a possibility to a probability as China begins to devalue. Knowing the globalist plans is key to stopping their operations. Educating the public that they are the social engineers, the economic and cultural masters that have shaped our world and that are pulling prosperity and decency down like a huge hydra pulling a ship into the North Atlantic. Here are the headlines on the China situation, and we've got some great interns in here now, and they're working on going back and getting our guests, Gerald Celente, Harry Dent, and so many others, myself, talking about China being the time bomb for the economic meltdown. And the situation with the EU and Europe and deflation in the general economy with inflation in other areas of the economy. And really no one knows exactly what that mix will be, but it's going to be serious. And again, I told you 5.5 years ago that I talked to billionaires, elitists, government insiders, you name it. Some of them here on air. And they were saying, get out of the United States within the next 5 years. That was 5 years ago. And that, quote, there wouldn't be a United States in 5 years. And I said, what does that mean? And they said, just what you say. You already know. Don't have to tell you. Now, I hope to heaven that they're wrong. I hope to heaven all these signs are wrong. But it's like if you already had 4 or 5 heart attacks and your hand, your left hand gets numb and your shoulder starts hurting and your heart starts hurting, chances are you're having another heart attack. And all the signs are there. And this time they're massing troops up against China and Russia because the one thing historically that'll happen is during a total meltdown, governments will start wars before that even happens to politically divert the public's anger towards an outside enemy. That's just 101. When the economy goes belly up, they take you to war. China roils markets for second day as yuan tumbles with stocks. China has been pumping hundreds of billions of dollars, translated into yuan, into their stock market, as you know, the last month, trying to keep it up unsuccessfully. Now they're dropping their currency even further, which will kill any imports of even raw material into their country and put them at an even bigger advantage still. And that's why you see the major Pacific fleet building up over there beforehand, because China began to break their deals with the globalists about 3 years ago. And I'm sorry, China is not Iraq or Assad. I mean, if you get in a war with the Chinese, they will fight. They'll just walk into machine gun fire and human wave attacks. Concerns China's economy is faltering, torpedoed stocks around the world for a second day and fueled demand for the safety of gold and treasuries. See, I told you in my gut, I think gold's going up this fall and Christmas. Even if there's an overall depression in other commodities, I just see elites buying it up, institutions buying it up quietly. That's just my gut. Maybe it's wrong. And maybe they'll manipulate and that won't happen. But it's already going up. China's yuan slipped 1% in offshore trading, leading the biggest two-day slide in Asian currency since 2008. While speculation of financial markets turmoil will force the Federal Reserve to delay raising interest rates, sent the dollar tumbling versus the yen and the euro. The weaker U.S. currency bolstered the investment appeal oil, while a measure of global equity slid the most in a month. That's out of Bloomberg Business. And it's like we had a time machine. If you were listening a year ago, 6 months ago, you heard about all this, remember? Not bragging. Mainstream media could have got all this right. They're paid to lie to you. I can't tell you how many major anchors have been down here or called me, or I've run into at events in New York or L.A., and they go, man, listen, get off our back. We're just doing our job. We know how bad it is. In fact, it's worse than you know. In fact, it's scary. If you don't tell anybody, I'm going to tell you a little... And I've had police chiefs, FBI, all to get me go, I know, we know, believe me, it's worse than you know. Well, then stand up against it. I mean, there's got to be some point where going along with the system isn't a suicide pact. Nobody says you got to make waves, but when the ship's capsizing, you got to climb up on top of it or you're going to drown. We'll be back with the rest on the China situation, on Hillary Clinton being FBI raided, and more. Legionnaire's disease is super scary. Said the biggest outbreak in history, and is now showing up in prisons and stuff, and they say it's not related. Pretty creepy. We're going to break some of that down. Here's another headline. Russia and NATO actively preparing for war. You're like, tell us something you haven't told us 500 times. I know I've told you that, but now it's in the London Telegraph, and governments are saying it. We've got a ton of news on the Hillary Clinton front, where the FBI has now raided the hard drives and seized them, and the DOJ has taken possession, which is also controlled by the very same people. She had satellite images, highly classified stuff on her computer. Again, top secret emails found as Clinton probe expands to key aides. Go to drudgereport.com. It's got the big blazoned headline. Hillary top secret email found. FBI seizes drives. DOJ takes possession. Satellite images. We'll break down some of the headlines at Infowars.com as well. Video. Cop repeatedly smashes student with baton for refusing to comply. Then caught lying on police report. Now arrested and fired. I got to say, in more and more cases, when you get bad cops, they're being arrested or fired, or both. Again, there's Kurt Nemo's article, NATO and Russia Prepare for War. He basically rewrote and expanded on the Reuters story. Calls for Smithsonian to remove exhibition honoring racist Planned Parenthood founder. Yeah, if you're going to dig up Confederate generals that had nothing to do with slavery and lie to a bunch of ignorant people, then you should certainly remove somebody who said blacks were subhuman and it should be killed. Minority Report style ad billboards shaped like eyes to watch consumers. We're going to go into that article that's up on Infowars.com. A really bizarre story, and this is NASA saying this, the universe is steadily deteriorating and so is the human race. What is happening? Inspector General says Clinton had top secret sensitive compartmentalized information. Angry customers to ditch Target stores after they remove gender-based signage. Yeah, boys' clothing section, girls' clothing, boys' toys, girls' toys. I mean, just cult-like attack on language. It's an occult attack on the species itself, not of this world. But I want to get particularly into the world economy first. Then we'll talk to Congressman Jones. He isn't just coming on about the 28 pages. He's coming on. He contacted us, which is great, because when he has breaking news, he contacts us about the move to try to unseat Boehner from the Speaker of the House position. So Congressman Jones joins InfoWars in about 25 minutes. On the move to remove Boehner. So we should tweet that Congressman will discuss plan afoot to remove Boehner from speakership live, Infowars.com/show. And then please retweet that out on Twitter, everybody, at Real Alex Jones, so that folks can tune in and hear this info. Because if we promote it, if we push it, Boehner's very unpopular with the GOP. He's got like a 12% approval rating in national polls. He needs to be removed. And we need to put somebody in there like Walter Jones, who has integrity and tells the truth. That's all we got to do is remove Nancy Pelosi and John Boehner and a few other nasty little creatures like Harry Reid from leadership positions. And we could take this country back. Most governors don't want to deep six the country. Most mayors don't want to deep six the country. Most county commissioners don't. Most people want prosperity and justice, but they're compartmentalized. They're not part of the main power structure, so they're not aware of what's really going on. And if you tell them, hey, Planned Parenthood secretly sells baby parts, they say no way. They'd go to jail for that. And so now that it comes out, they go, okay, let's start criminal investigations in 14 states looking to start indicting Planned Parenthood. See, we have to be laughed at, tell the truth, force the truth out, make it safe for others to look at it, and then everything will collapse in the enemy operation. I've told you many times, their strongest point and their weakest point is the same thing. They're over-the-top insane, over-the-top diabolical, over-the-top evil. And the average person just does not want to grab a child out of a playground and torture him for a month at a subterranean torture base while worshiping Satan. The average person doesn't want to get with 15 people in black robes and torture a 2-year-old for 3 days, sucking the blood out of them, like Satanists do with cutting them all over their body. The average person doesn't want to sell baby parts and buy Lamborghinis. The average person doesn't want to put a brain-eating acid in the water to brain damage people. The average person doesn't want 1 in 3 by 2025, that's the CDC believes, 1 in 3 will be wearing diapers and basically a football helmet, not knowing who they are. I mean, it's just epic, legendary, over-the-top, 500 times Twilight Zone. We live it. The average person doesn't believe DynCorp loads up C-130s full of little kids and flies them into black holes. But it's been in the news. Been in congressional hearings. Nobody got in trouble. You take a Gardasil shot, you're going to have serious autoimmune problems. You're going to have fertility problems. And sometimes you're going to end up dying or in a wheelchair for the rest of your life. And we knew it during the trials 10 years ago. It came out. It's been banned in more than, 10 countries, 11 countries? Or restricted? And you don't even hear that here. They're testing being able to maim everybody and get away with it. Not in Kansas anymore. And it's my job to smash through the lies and disinformation, to crash through it, to blow holes in it. It's my job to be destroyed. It's my job to go in and explode. And then lead everybody else in to defeat the enemy. And I'm not the only one doing it. But I'll tell you, I was analyzing this morning while I was psychoanalyzing myself, being retrospective, and I thought, man, why is it I'm not afraid? Why is it I'm ready to die? Why is it I don't care and I'm so committed? Because I realize the whole species is dying, and it's a normal instinct. And then the cherry on top is I've been involved in abortions, and I've been involved in bad things, and so every minute is a blessing, and whatever God does to me, it's what I deserve. I am free, and I repent of everything I've been involved in, and I just offer myself up to resist evil. And it doesn't mean I'm perfect, doesn't mean I have all the answers, but let me tell you, God is with me, and I can feel it. The providence is there, and I just wish other people could share in this, because it's an epic, epic, epic time to be alive. And I will do whatever it takes to not be a disgraceful, evil person when I die. And I just feel so sorry for people out there that have no common sense and who don't realize that all that matters is who you are, your soul. The first thing the world tells you is you don't have a soul. And then all these major elites, when I've infiltrated their organizations and their groups, they are the most superstitious, occult-obsessed people you could ever imagine, and they don't want you to know about any of this stuff, so you're totally spiritually blind, spiritually stupid, so that you don't understand that they're using occult systems of manipulation to control the planet. All occult means is hidden. The CIA, that's been secret since 1947 and above the law, is occult. We are the anti-occult. We're here to expose the fraud. We're here to bring it out in the light. Because vampires, parasites, roaches don't like the sun. I love the sun. And we're going to drag them kicking and screaming out at high noon out of their crypts. And we don't have to do anything to them. We just have to spiritually drag the enemy out in the open square, and they will burst into flames. The allegory is so true. They will burn. They will turn to dust in front of our eyes the minute we recognize the light. But to bring light into the world, to bring God's light into the world, we have to be the vessels for that light. We have to be the conduit for that light. And that doesn't mean going to the church and acting how moral you are and how you're perfect and how you never looked at pornography or you never drank a beer or you're high and mighty and more proper than everyone else. That's not what God's looking for, a bunch of Pharisees. God's looking for people that love justice and love God and love innocence and love creativity and love truth and who are willing to stand up against demons, who are willing to stand up against corrupt people, who are willing to get on that field and who aren't afraid. A lot of you out there don't believe in God. You don't believe in spiritual things. You don't believe in other dimensions, which have been proven. Let me tell you something about the metaphysical world that's guaranteed. It's based on free will. And you open and close the gate to evil and to good, to apathy and to strength. You have to make the decision that you want to see the Matrix. You have to make the decision that you want to go down the rabbit hole. You have to make the decision and open yourself up. And the truth is, you think you're not open to those forces. If you're not open to good in your mind, you're open to bad. So the truth is, you're already wide open, standing in the middle of the road, the most dangerous place to be, lukewarm. You ought to make a conscious decision, and while you're alive on this planet, give it one shot. When you look at all this fantasticness around you, and you don't think there's more, there's a lot more on heaven and earth than in all your books, to quote Shakespeare. I want to get into the economy. I want to briefly tell folks that we have a very exciting announcement. We got more of the Brain Force, the proprietary product. In fact, I'm going to get Anthony in here later to cover some medical news. And maybe when he comes in to cover health and medical news, he can go over this because he worked with the chemists and designers with the known compounds that are known to boost brain activity. But there are now reviews on this because the first batch came in a few months ago. It sold out in 4 days. Another batch has come in, and the factory could not supply, the laboratory could not supply a bigger batch. So one-tenth of this sold out in just the first 3 hours of sale. I predict it'll sell out by tomorrow. If you want to try Brain Force, haven't been able to get it in the last 2 months, Brain Force is back in. Then in about 2 weeks, we have a larger shipment coming in. They say might be 6 weeks for all I know. And it's because it's hard to get the organic concentrated ingredients. If I'd use cruddier ones, it'd be no problem. So we're kind of victims of our own fact that we want to have something so good. But clean, healthy energy, waking up the mind. Brain Force is back, and I predict it'll be sold out within 48 hours at current sales rates, and we appreciate you purchasing it. This place costs a lot of money to run and operate, and I used to want to stay small, but I had enemies try to destroy me, try to set me up, demonize me for even trying to have 5 employees and even having a modest house and a modest vehicle. So I said, you know what? I have all these enemies. They must not want me to become successful. I have a responsibility to fund a larger operation and to not reach 2 or 3 million a week like I was reaching 15 years ago, but to reach 20 million a week like we're reaching now, and 40, 50, 100. You know, we're going to go all the way. We're committed. So I'm so proud of Rachel Maddow and MSNBC demonizing the fact that we sell high-quality supplements that even on the herbal nerd sites, they say, you know, five-star. Because this is the organic, concentrated, highest-quality nutraceuticals at very competitive prices. That's a win-win. And we're going to grow even more, God willing. We're going to go all the way. And we're going to be successful because Providence is on our side, at least for now. And we're thankful for that. So thank you all for your support. But if you want to get this incredibly high-quality product, it's available right now at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. And briefly, here are some of the new BrainForce reviews. This is a 5.0. It has a 5.9 right now for this product. The average is 4.8. And that's with the Power Review site, one of the most highly respected out there. Excellent product. I feel great and very noticeably efficient. A great energy, which also left me feeling no side effects. Sad, the bottle is almost empty, and I can't wait until it's back in stock. That's Tom Biggs from New Jersey. Thank you, Tom, for your support. Here's another one. Grandma Zach, Rolling Meadows, Illinois. My husband and I both take BrainForce every day, and it's helped us remember better and function better. Husband stated before taking, he would sometimes feel like he was in a fog. Since starting BrainForce, he no longer has that problem. I would recommend this to a friend. 50 is the new 30, Atlanta, Georgia. I'm an herbalist nut. I never put trust in traditional medicine. I am upwards of 40 and need a boost. I've been listening to Alex Jones since 2007 and found him to be reputable. So I said I'll try Supermel Vitality. Hallelujah, it works. It works too well. No side effects. I don't know if I'm addicted. Gotta have it. Seriously, I've found lightning in a bottle. I've found Pounce Dion's Fountain of Youth, if I pronounce that right. Yes, I would recommend it. Here's another one I'm going to stop. Gary in Barrel City, Texas. Tastes great. Gives him more stamina, more energy. Feel great. Sleep better. Yeah, it does that because it jacks you up during the day. And just a great product. And see, it's got the known compounds that are in your brain. One of the compounds is actually in the brain. It's prescription in Europe. Anthony will briefly pop in the next hour and talk about it. He's got other news, but I want him to go over the science of it and show you some of the studies. And so I only take one or two a day. And noticeably, people have seen the energy, the stamina, been able to shoot more reports, do more, get more done. And it doesn't have speed in it to just speed you up. It does have some Uramate. That's a different type of caffeine. But a small dose of that, but it'll definitely knock your socks off as well. So BrainForce is back in, and it is not my goal to have this stuff come in small lots and sell out to create artificial scarcity. We want to be able to have it, promote it, and fund our operation. So we should have more in 2 weeks. It shouldn't have any sellouts of that for a while. Also, Super Male Vitality is back in. It was sold out for a couple months, and it's concentrated herbs and key compounds known to get your glands going again. You can see the thousands of reviews on that product at InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Okay, I'm going to get into China in detail when we come back. And then Congressman Walter Jones joins us, and we'll get into the move to remove Boehner. And we'll also segue into the announcements of attacking Assad and their military that's fighting ISIS. And how outrageous that is. We have Jeb Bush's comments backing it. China, that the mainstream media has been telling us is a great economy the last few years. Stock market's been imploding. They've been devaluing their currency by design to outcompete other competitors when no one can even compete with China because things are so rigged. Stock markets are down across the world. Here's the headline from MarketWatch. China could trigger the biggest financial rout since 2008. But don't worry, they'll have a global stabilization package, trillions to the bankers, and more free interest rates for them, but higher for us. Don't worry, they'll have a managed global economy, the next step to save us. So much for that one-time correction. The People's Bank of China let the yuan drop again overnight, fixing the currency 1.6 below Tuesday's close, following the 1.9 devaluation heard around the world a day ago. So massive devaluations daily. And the average person goes, I don't care what goes over there in China. Well, if you dig in your backyard, you run into them. It affects us completely because our entire industrial base has basically been shipped there. All we do is print money, and then I guess the Chinese women come here to have their babies for free. And if you don't pay for it as a taxpayer, you're a racist. Of course, you can't go to China and have a baby for free. They'd laugh at you. Maybe harvest your organs, but that's okay because they're not white. Deutsche Bank, for one, is predicting that the yuan is overvalued by around 10%. So if the yuan continues to weaken, things could get a lot darker for markets. And stocks aren't dealing with the new China reality that we've seen so far. The Crack Market blog says the U.S. market reaction in S&P fell 1% today and yesterday, and futures are pointing sharply lower. Here's another one, Financial Times of London. What's next? A China housing crash? And that's the big one that most of our experts agree is the key trigger they're looking at. Could be war in the Middle East. Could be war with Russia. Could be a major scandal. Could be a new Enron-type deal. But the big one could be new derivatives news or a state or major city going under like Chicago or L.A. But the big one is the Chinese housing market. Prices have fallen, but high deposit required means low risk of crisis. China's equity markets cool down. Its currency is devalued. Attention will return to the question of whether the country's property market is heading for a fall. In my view, the boom days are over. But with buyers required to put at least 30% down cash, the risk of a crisis are low. Unless they just walk away. They're always telling us it's low as it all happens. And they're not mentioning that they forced all the people out of the countryside into these cities. And then as their manufacturing economy goes belly up during a global depression, that's what we're in. Under a global depression, it'll cause incredible destabilization in a country that has thousands of riots a month. China's currency devaluation could spark tidal wave of deflation. London Guardian. Western central banks advised to resist raising interest rates and told to prepare to ward off deflationary slump in the face of cheaper Chinese exports. Make no mistake, this is the start of something big, something ugly. Citibank economist Albert Edwards rarely minces his words, but his reaction to China's devaluation, which sent shockwaves through global markets, underlined how powerfully Beijing's move may be felt thousands of miles away. And in the next hour, after Walter Jones leaves us, Congressman, we'll get more into that. China's currency devaluation sends global exports reeling. China's devaluation marks escalation of currency war. And then, coming up, 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash has become even more likely. Who keeps warning you about this? Gold and silver surges, dollar slumps. It's all coming up. Second hour, tell your friends and family, tune in. This is an emergency. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now into hour number two. Congressman Walter Jones with big news on the move to remove Boehner will be joining us coming up at the start of the next segment. Then we've got some major breaking health news. We're going to have a guest in studio on that subject. And then we're going to continue with open phones in the third hour, specifically dealing with what's happening in China, devaluing their currency almost 4 points in just the last 2 days to further undermine everybody else's finished goods, value-added products around the world, and really breaking the deal they have with the globalists to make them the major industrial city, because it's kind of a rollerball globalist model where different countries under globalism, one's a military country, one's the industrial country, one's the energy sector, one's the entertainment sector, media sector. So there's not war anymore to make everybody dependent. Well, the globalists just used that to consolidate power for themselves and then sold weapons in the back to destabilize things even more. So that's coming up. 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash has become even more likely. The story by Michael Snyder is excellent. It's up on Infowars.com. Did you see what just happened? I'm going to cover this in detail, but let's get into it right now. The devaluation of the yuan by China triggered the largest one-day drop of the currency in modern era. This caused other global currencies to crash relative to the U.S. dollar. The price of oil hit a six-year low, and stock markets all over the world were rattled. The Dow fell 212 points on Tuesday, and Apple stock plummeted another 5% as we hurtle towards the absolutely critical months of September and October. Yeah, if it's an organized, orchestrated collapse, it'll be in October so they can fearmonger, get things fixed, get a power grab package and a bailout package by November, and then still have a Christmas. But if it crashes in November or December, I don't think it's rigged then. And boy, it could go all the way. But don't worry, the elites are headed to their bunkers right now, but we shouldn't fearmonger. If we're lucky and can stop this or slow it down or have a smooth landing, then it's, oh, really, where was the global crisis, Alex? You only predicted it would come and it came, but it wasn't that bad. Don't you people sound like idiots now? And I wish I wasn't right. I wish I wasn't right about all of it. But we don't make stuff up. You know, knock on wood, I have never been sued for libel or slander. Other people threaten it, and then I just have my lawyers contact them and go, well, here's our evidence and here's our source. So you can sue our source if you want, who said another publication or a document. But usually we're just going off an admitted document, a court case, an admission. It's not us saying it. 95% of what we cover is open source intelligence. 5% is my analysis and where I think it's going. And that's proven very accurate. But it's not hard when you have a historical context. And the patriots worldwide, people that want stability, want decency, that are throughout the system, it's not just evil out there acting, operating. We've been trying to stop all this. So we're like holding the gate back with the enemy trying to come in. And you're like, you say there's an enemy horde out there and like swords are sticking through the wall and people are climbing over the parapet and falling on top people and fireballs are shooting in. And you're like, oh, you claim there's fireballs. And then one flies over and burns their hair. And they're like, I don't see any fireballs as their hair is on fire. So you claim they're selling baby parts. Dead baby plops right beside them. I don't know what you're talking about. You claim Margaret Sanger's a Nazi? You're the racist. Salon said so. We wear pink sweaters and talk with a lisp. That means we're intellectual. Margaret Sanger was never involved in anything. And Christ was not the Messiah, as Pastor Hagee says as well. We'll be right back. Welcome to the second hour of the broadcast on this Wednesday, the 12th day of August, 2015. Coming up, the shocking degeneration of the Chinese stock market and their currency, the yuan, and how that's going to affect the United States, with Congressman, former Congressman Ron Paul and others warning that the day of reckoning is coming probably this fall or this winter. And we have Gerald Celente, we have Harry Dent, we have Max Kaiser, we have Peter Schiff, we have a whole bunch of financial experts that have been accurately breaking down what's coming, joining us this week and next week. Joining us now is Representative Walter Jones, jones.house.gov, and 28pages.org. And, of course, he is a congressman serving his ninth term from North Carolina. And he joins us to break down the huge development that he and others have been spearheading to try to remove Speaker Boehner from his position. If we could get rid of Pelosi out of leadership, Harry Reid in the Senate, people like Boehner when he's not playing golf with Obama, he's defending Obamacare. We can't defund Planned Parenthood. We can't stop partial birth abortion. We can't control the borders. We can't keep the power plants on, even though there's no law to shut them off, because Boehner, whether he's blackmailed or whether he's paid off or whether he's had a lobotomy, we don't know. But with a Republican speaker of the House like this, you might as well just put Nancy Pelosi back in there. At least we know who she is. So Representative Walter Jones is here to give us the inside baseball. We're very thankful to him on what happened last week and the fact that this could still happen if people get behind it. And this could be a real game changer. I don't have to tell the audience that if we're able to remove these rhinos out of the power structure. And then we'll look at federal lawsuit could reveal the contents of 28 pages omitted from 9/11 report implicating the Saudi government quarterbacking the operation. And, of course, Congressman Jones has been exposing that. Now they're saying take out Assad to defeat ISIS when ISIS is al-Qaeda, Saudi Arabian funded. This is the Republican and Democratic leadership playing on the ignorance of the public, saying take out Assad, who has been fighting al-Qaeda, to stop al-Qaeda. So just incredible. Walter Jones is an expert on this as well. Thank you so much for joining us, sir. And please give us an update on exactly what's happening, because the mainstream media is not covering the fact that Boehner is in some trouble, isn't he?
Yes, and Alex, thank you. It's always an honor and pleasure to be on your show, and I appreciate you telling the truth to the American people. And on this issue, let me, for those that maybe not as familiar as you are and I, we in the Congress have been very frustrated by John Boehner and the fact that he does not follow conservative principles. You can blame President Obama for spending money, but he can't raise the debt ceiling unless we in Congress pass legislation to allow him to raise that debt ceiling. So let me go to where we are now. Mark Meadows, who is also a congressman from North Carolina, he's from the mountain area. I'm from the coastal area. And we had been talking for months now about what we could do. We tried to get into a second round back in January with Mr. Boehner, trying to get 29 votes to send it to a second round, and then maybe we could get him out by in January. That did not happen. So the frustration has continued. And we met about 5 or 6 weeks ago, Ted Yeho from Florida, Thomas Massey from Kentucky, myself, and Mark Meadows, talking about what can we do, what kind of opportunities do we have as members of Congress to bring the Congress back to the people. It's their house, not our house. And so Mr. Meadows came up with this idea of vacating the chair. So he and Thomas Massey worked together on a resolution. It's H. Resolution 385, H. Resolution 385. Your listeners can go on anybody's website, mine or anyone else, and find this. Let me read two parts of this very quickly to get us talking, Alex. The first is this in the resolution, whereas the Speaker of the House of Representatives for the 114th Congress has endeavored to consolidate power and centralize decision-making, bypassing the majority of the 435 members of the Congress and the people they represent. Just another one. Whereas the Speaker uses the power of the office to punish members who vote according to their conscience instead of the will of the Speaker. And the last one, whereas the Speaker continues to direct the Rules Committee to limit meaningful amendments, to limit debate on the House floor, and to subvert a straightforward legislative process. They're just three of the eight whereas is in the resolution. Mr. Meadows, Mr. Massey, I, and Mr. Yeho have joined him in co-sponsoring this resolution. Why I am honored and pleased to be on your show again, Alex, is that any of your listeners, whatever state they might be in, if they would call their member of Congress, all of them are home now for the next 3-4 weeks, actually, and call them and ask them to tell the person that answers the phone to remind that congressman that he or she could join in this resolution to vacate the chair. And if we can get enough votes, what will happen? We will have a straight up and down vote on who the next speaker should be to replace John Boehner. And we really, I have nothing against the speaker personally. He's a good man personally, but he is not a policy leader. And we need to return this country back, this government back to the people.
Again, Congressman Walter Jones of North Carolina joins us. You can go to jones.house.gov and read the bill. We just put it on screen. You can also read the Daily Signal article. Conservative congressman seeks to oust John Boehner as House Speaker. Look, you're a gentleman, and I respect that. I know Boehner reportedly is very nice, very charming, very friendly. But then he will viciously, as you mentioned, through his whip and others, you might explain how that works, go after members of the House that don't follow his orders. So I don't care how nice he is when he sticks a knife in your back. He needs to be removed. whether it's on partial birth abortion that we had the votes on, or whether it's Obamacare, or whether it's shutting off the power plants, or the open borders, or the debt limit. I mean, this is one of the, I mean, he makes Newt Gingrich look good, and Gingrich was a sellout. This guy is completely out of control, and we need to start a hashtag like Fire Boehner. Let's put that out at Real Alex Jones. Fire Boehner, and then let's link to the resolution that's linked on Congressman Jones's site. But there's the headline from Politico: House conservatives seek John Boehner's ouster. And let's get this moving to hashtag Fire Boehner. I mean, we've recalled Republican governors that act like this. We've recalled other people. I mean, it's outrageous just on Obamacare alone. But explain to people how all this parliamentary procedure works, because I know they were going to bring it up for a vote to try to kill this bill. I'm told they then learned they didn't have enough votes to kill it. Since then, I've been trying to follow it. Explain to us the Byzantine machinations.
Okay, Alex, the H Resolution 385 is now in the Rules Committee. The Rules Committee will be the committee that will determine to send this back to the full House, meaning back to the floor of the House, for a vote. And you're exactly right. The day after Mark Meadows put this in, Mr. Boehner's people were thinking about go ahead and bring it out of the Rules Committee, back on the floor, and kill it before the August break. You're exactly right. What happened was that the Jim Jordan from Ohio got word to the leadership that if you try this, you might be embarrassed. Because let me remind your listeners of this. Every member sitting on the floor of the House will have a chance to vote, to vacate the chair, and then that would mean there would be another vote for the Speaker of the House, and it would be a new person if that happened. So that's where it is. And so what we're trying to do, the ones I have mentioned, Yoho, Massey, Mark Meadows, and myself, Walter Jones, we're trying to get on as many shows, people who have a national audience like yourself, to talk about this issue, because there's so many things going on in Washington that it's not the people's house anymore, Alex. It's controlled by money. It's the special interest house, not the people's house. We want to have a Speaker of the House that will let us do our job and represent the people of our district being threatened.
Well, again, I'm going to skip this network break because we just have you to the bottom of the hour. Congressman Walter Jones joins us, and I tell you, it's very humbling, sir, and quite frankly, borders on obscene for you to be thanking myself for having you on when you're the one going up against this mafia. You're the one exposing Saudi Arabia and 9/11. You're the one doing this, and I know you don't like praise, but people need to be praying for you. You've got a lot of courage, and quite frankly, you're doing some things that even Ron Paul wasn't doing when he was congressman. He went after the Federal Reserve. You're going right at the heart of some really dangerous people. So please don't thank us, sir. We want to thank you for working so hard. And again, it's not about praise, but folks need to understand the position you're in, working so hard, doing all these interviews, helping get the bills out in the face of this guy and in the threats. Let's talk about how Boehner threatens people and the way he twists arms to keep things like Obamacare afloat.
Well, Alex, let me give the Trade Promotion Authority, TPA, which was a vote about 3 weeks ago, maybe four now, and I think this is what really brought us to a head, to be honest about it. We had the votes on the rule. As you know, a rule has to be voted on by the House before you get to the debate on the bill itself. We actually had the votes to kill the rule. Mr. Boehner and the president wanted this bill to pass to give the president the Trade Promotion Authority, meaning he could bypass Congress with any type of treaty, and all Congress could do is to vote up or down, no ability to amend it. So we would give away our right to amend. So let me go back to the rule now. You have to have a rule that sets the parameters of the debate. So we had the votes to kill the rule. Three members of the Republican House who had been in the SWIP organization had voted with us on this rule. What happened a day later? They were kicked off the whip team. That's not a big thing. Then we've had other members who voted against Boehner who were denied the right to go on these overseas trips with other members of Congress, meaning Republicans and Democrats. I have a bill that is a minor thing in a way, but let me explain it very quickly. A dear friend of mine, a 55-year-old federal bankruptcy judge, died suddenly of a heart attack. We have the courthouse here in my district. We wanted to name the courthouse for this judge, Judge Randy Dabb. He's a Republican, but the Democrats, everybody said he was a very fair-minded person. And they won't move that bill. I've got it through the committee, but they won't move it to the floor of the House.
So what they do is they won't move your bills. You want to go out for trade for your state on these trade missions. They won't let you go. They basically cut you off. But bigger than that, it's Boehner's been caught, as you know. It's been in the news with the Democrats meeting with big think tanks and big lenders and big donors on how to go after the Tea Party. So he's been quietly, while telling the Tea Party to play nice, he's been trying to kill the libertarian constitutionalist movement that could save this country. I mean, I've got to say it. Boehner is worse than Benedict Arnold when it comes to selling this country out.
Well, you're right. And Alex, let me say this. The point is that when we are elected to represent the people of our district, we're not sent to Washington to be a puppet for the Speaker of the House. And that's one thing this resolution, I hope your listeners will look it up, H. Resolution 385. We're there to represent the people of our district, the people across this nation. No one should dictate to our conscience how we should vote. And if I have a minute or two, I'd like to explain something that happened recently.
Please, sir, you've got the floor.
Okay. We had a bill two months ago that the Republicans brought to the floor of the House that would allow the mobile home companies, in writing their contracts to someone that wants to buy a mobile home, to raise the interest rate from 8 to 11%. Warren Buffett, who is a billionaire, in his financial portfolio owns 91% of all the mobile home businesses in America. And I could not vote for that because in my district, the eastern part of North Carolina, we have over 45,000 mobile homes where people are living. We have people every day that the best they can do is to buy a mobile home. I could not raise the interest rate from 8 to 11 on that person trying to buy a mobile home to help Warren Buffett become a million, have more millions going to his billions.
And let's not forget, he gets billions and 0% rates and is the biggest recipient of the banker bailout while he lobbies for regulations that actually make it more expensive to be able to get affordable housing because he basically controls the regulators and is exempt from it. I mean, this guy is a monster.
Alex, that's why we need to change the leadership of the House. We need somebody up there in that position that understands that those of us elected from districts in America, we represent the people of this country, not the wishes of the special interest.
You know, it's funny you mention that. They used to have these payday loan laws, especially in the South, left over from the end of the Civil War. And now they allow like 20, 30% interest and stuff a year, just ripping people off. I mean, it is shameful what Congress, but also these states have been doing. So I commend you for that. Bottom line, we've got a shot at least wounding him politically and scaring him to back off. But I think from other folks I've talked to, and correct me if I'm wrong, Congressman, we're pretty close to actually being able to unseat Boehner if the people get behind this.
Alex, if the people would get behind this and call their member of Congress during this next 3 to 4 weeks, tell them about H. Resolution 385 and ask that member of Congress to join those of us who have put our necks out there and say that we need to return the House of Representatives to the people of America. That's why Donald Trump is so popular. I mean, really, people are frustrated and fed up, and most of that frustration and being fed up is with Washington, D.C.
And then he acts like he's from the outside, and they start worshiping him. I mean, I like a lot of the stuff he's actually saying. My only concern is the fact that he wasn't like that in the past. But people change. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Let me ask you that question. What do you think is going to happen to Trump if he runs third party and helps Hillary win, or if he drops out and plays hanky-panky? I hope he realizes that he is going to be anathema.
Well, let me say up front, I have already endorsed Rand Paul. That's my choice. And the only thing I was trying to make the point with Donald Trump is that the frustration is deep. The frustration is so deep that, and I can say Bernie Sanders, look at the crowds he's drawing. People are just tired and fed up. And one way we can change the direction of this direction is to replace the Speaker of the House. And if, again, if your listeners would follow your call and my call, and pick up the phone, call their members of Congress, H. Resolution 385, and let's return the House back to the people of America.
I agree, Congressman. In the 3 or 4 minutes we have left, I just want to make the point again before we get into the situation with 28 pages. We have some breaking news there that basically getting a good speaker would be like winning the White House. The Congress controls the purse. It controls what bills right. can move. The reason they're able to get this agenda through is they have Republican leadership working with the Democrats. This is as big as the election, removing Boehner and getting somebody good in there. And I think to get rid of him, we need a few members of the House to stand up and say, I want to be elected, and this is what I'll do. I think if people challenge him and we get the leadership to not just go after him, but people say, you know, here's a field of folks. Here's what we pledge to do. Yep. Maybe a coalition of 10 members of the House to say any of us could be speaker. Vote for us. Here's our pledge. Then you'd see a grassroots movement and we could unseat him. So hopefully you've been moving the ball. What do you think of that idea, sir?
Well, I think it's a great idea. The one thing that you know and I know, if anyone that would like to offer themselves as a speaker, they want to know that they can win this first step. And the first step is to vacate the chair.
So you have to at least get it introduced to open the idea of being able to have the vote.
No, absolutely. If we had this vote on the floor of the House and there would be people that would be smelling the blood, so to speak, they would start offering themselves up as a possibility. I think there would be at least 3, 4, or 5. If they thought
sure.
that Boehner was going to be taken out of office, they would offer themselves. It would happen that quick.
So it's like fishing for sharks. We got to get him on the line with the vacate the chair boat. Then we can haul him in and gaff him.
There you go.
In closing, sir, shifting gears into your dangerous and valiant move that's now exposed in headlines all over the world with other members of the House, that Saudi Arabia quarterback 9/11, you've seen the pages.
Yep.
More of this is coming out. U.S. ex-intelligence chief came out and said on ISIS's rise, it was a willful Washington decision to back them against Assad. Now Jeb Bush is saying, and Obama is saying, they're going to start bombing Assad to, quote, stop ISIS. That's the craziest thing I ever heard. What's your view on that?
I agree with you totally. And if my brother had sent 4,000 Americans to die in an unnecessary war, I don't believe I'd be making those statements. I'm talking about George Bush going into Iraq. We never had to go into Iraq. It was manufactured intelligence.
Sure, and Jeb at first defended it. Remember that?
Oh, yeah, I do. I'm being kind of rude, but I'm going to tell you, we had no business going into Iraq. Taking out Saddam is part of the problem that we got with the Middle East right now.
Well, sure. Look at what we've got is Saudi Arabia again. With its proxy army taking over, and now the White House has announced bombing of Assad, who's fighting the Saudi Arabian proxy army.
Well, Alex, that's why Jim McGovern and I and Barbara Lee have been pushing John Boehner to let us have a new debate and vote on the authorization of military force. They complain about Obama this and Obama that, but they're letting him go just decide whatever he wants to do to expand the war without any action of Congress. And Madison said it is the legislative branch that will debate and discuss the justification for war.
Yes, sir. Well, again, everybody's got to get behind this. People want to spend all their time about the election. That's fine. Controlling the House, getting a patriot in, that is the key. We've got good men and women up there. Let's do it. Let's get behind it. Thank you so much, Congressman Walter Jones, jones.house.gov. And give folks that resolution number one more time.
H Resolution 385.
385. Thank you so much. And please,
thank you, Alex.
Please come back soon, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right. God bless Walter Jones. Let me tell you, that guy is soft-spoken, but he's a real patriot and a real man. What he's doing is very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. You need to pray for him. Thank you so much for joining us. Anthony Gucciardi's here to talk about the economy with us. Great InfoWars analyst and writer for InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.com, and also StoryLeak.com. After he leaves us in the entire third hour, we're going to open the phones up and really dig into what's happening to the global economy. But most of the world is in a depression. Other areas that aren't in full-bore depression, I mean, that's admitted the world's in depression, are in serious recession. But now the economy is so rigged under globalism that it's selected. like in a mega city like Austin that's been chosen as a smart growth example of saying, oh, it's a boom because they adopted globalism and the other cities adopt, and like Spain did, and it, you know, totally collapses. So this is an incredible time to be alive, and we're going to be going over 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash has become even more likely. China could trigger the biggest financial rout since 2008. All the exact same policies, they just intensified it. Well, yeah, you give them diplomatic immunity, unlimited money for what they engineered, they're going to do more. You mean I get power and unlimited money out of too big to fail? Well, I'll do it again. And it looks like they're going to do it 8 years later. So we've got that. China's currency devaluation could spark a tidal wave of deflation. What's next? A China housing crash. Financial Times of London. And again, if you are a longtime listener, you've heard this over and over again, but back when nobody else was covering. And I want to be so clear on this. We're not up here high-horsing, going, look, we told you we were right. The point is, we know what we're talking about. Where'd you hear about fluoride being bug poison first? Where'd you hear about glyphosate giving you cancer first? Where'd you hear about Planned Parenthood and baby parts first? Where'd you hear about the New World Order and a planetary government plan and that the Vatican was going to endorse it soon? Here. And their whole program is about keeping you in the dark. I mean, I go back to this analogy or this example all the time. It's happened many times where I'm talking to Rolling Stone or I'm talking to the Wall Street Journal or I'm talking to the LA Times or I'm talking to Nightline, Good Morning America. I mean, to the point now, when they call, Newsweek just called, wanted to come down here last week and do some profile on me. And I said, I'll give you 20, 30 minutes over the phone. I don't have time to sit around and have you around my office where you guys act like, you know, for your piece, you came and did an investigation. That's just all part of the play acting. Just go do your own theater, make up whatever you want. I don't care. And they'll sit there and go, so you believe there's a world government being formed? And I'm like, yeah, let me show you 50 quotes and clips. And I'll show them clips. They go, oh, Gordon Brown is talking about another world government than you're talking about. The host of ABC Nightly News for Nightline in that control room looked at me and I showed him clips. And he went, yeah, they're talking about a different world government than you are. And then they had the piece and said, Alex believes there's a plan for world government. No, I don't believe jack squat. I don't believe the Pacific Ocean is off the coast of California. It's true. I don't believe George Washington was our first president. I know it. I don't believe fluoride's bug poison. I know it. I've read the books by these people bragging about how they're doing it to us. That's how stupid they think we are. And so the nightmare can end the minute we wake up to the fact that there is a globalist predatory plan against us, and the normal action is to get aggressive, to get upset, and politically take our cities, counties, states, and federal government back, and then to have grand juries. If they're going to indict Dinesh D'Souza for campaign finance for a crooked, you know, fingernail, believe me, the globalist, Hillary Clinton, all of them can go to prison too. Hillary Clinton's been raided by the FBI. That's what they did. They said they raided her hard drives. No, they raided her staffers' offices. And sure enough, it's full of classified crap. Petraeus told his girlfriend in Pillow Talk, obviously, in my view, you know, somebody's an operative in there, sex ops, about some classified stuff, so he got indicted. I'm not defending Petraeus, but that's just a witch hunt. Hillary takes money from third world dictators at the State Department to her foundation. Totally illegal on its face, and then takes the export ban off weapons. She shipped the weapons to ISIS. We had Tosh Plumlee on 2 years ago telling you, before it was even in the news. Now it's all admitted. CIA whistleblower. And what I'm getting at is not just me as a host, I'm nobody, but my crew, our guest, our analysis, we are the tip of the spear. And I only say that because the enemy knows that. And it's got dirty tricks ops going in overdrive right now, which I'm not whining about. I asked to be put in the arena with these people. I love it. I want to be in the thick of the fight. The point is, you need to just know there is a fight going on, and we got the folks here like Walter Jones, who's exposing the Saudis quarterback 9/11 with criminals inside the government, and there was a stand-down order. Do you realize how dangerous that is? I'll guarantee you they've sat around and talked about blowing his plane up when he's on an aircraft. I guarantee it. Killing him's been discussed. Killing Rand Paul's been discussed. Killing me's been discussed. Killing Matt Drudge has been discussed. Killing Joseph Farah's been discussed. You better believe in these criminal councils. And why they haven't done it is they know it'll blow up in their face if they do it. But they may get so cornered, a nuke goes off in a major city, and then it's just a footnote. A bunch of people had heart attacks or died or got hit by cars. That's how this works. And let me tell you, the minute that happens, canary in the coal mine, Katie bar the door, there's a full-on depression, war with the Russians, war with the Chinese. If they go that far, folks, they're going all out. Because John Corzine, former head of Goldman Sachs, that's the top of the pyramid financially, he took people's money, $2 billion of other people's private bank accounts, and made 40-to-1 bets. These people are insane. They're insane. They're mentally ill. And I just sit here watching the phantasm, the fantastical bizarreness of having hundreds of books on our bookshelves, hundreds written by them. Tragedy and Hope, Eco-Science, The Technotronic Era. Written by Kissinger and Quigley and Holdren and all of them just bragging about it. People keep asking, people are not going, actually, this guy says it's true. I'm seeing all the internet people going, whoa, this stuff's actually real. Well, everything he says, exactly, you can go read it for yourself. They thought you were so dumb. Criminals always brag that they write books that only the academia read laughing. It's like Gruber. When he went before not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, but six that I saw, academic boards with other top professors and then to student groups, to PhD-level student groups, teaching them how to lie. That's what you get a PhD in now, is how he was so proud of his deception. That's how dumb they think we are. They go on C-SPAN and talk about lying to people and giggle and look at him. He's got a little neck and little weak eyes. Can you imagine just get that guy in the ring? Here's your baseball bat, punk. You want to run around scamming people and double and triple their prices and laugh about it? You're a real man? Pick up the baseball bat, scumbag. We'll find out who really's ready here. Those people couldn't walk around in America 100 years ago. Think that's funny, screwing people over? I don't think it's funny. And they tell lies everywhere. They write books, the same thing, how they're screwing you and your family, how they're screwing me and my family. Well, I'm sick of getting screwed by a bunch of scum. That's the worst part. These people are weak and they're stupid. But we're too naive to admit the truth. Excuse me, Anthony, I got you in here to cover some news, and I kind of went on a rant. Let's talk about the economy, the state of the world, and the fact that we as the Liberty Movement, not just this show is just in a composite eye, one of the big nodes, but we're just a small part of it. We're just a focal point of what's already beneath the surface. The Liberty Movement needs to be arrogant. We've learned that from Donald Trump. When you're right and you're confident, they call it arrogance, but it's really the fact that you know you're correct. We were right about everything. You were right about it when you got laughed at by your family. And it's time to say, we told you so. Now, are you going to listen to us now and get out of this? It's another stupid Terminator line. Come with me if you want to live. It's coming down to that. And I'm not telling you, come with me and raise taxes. Come with me and do what I say. Come with common sense in the Republic and Americana and low taxes and local government and decentralization and family and liberty and freedom and sovereignty and honor. It's not come with me if you want to live. Come with me if you want to thrive and not be a slave. The globalists are like holding a beach ball down. You know the human ingenuity that's taken us to space and all the culture and science we've got? And ancient societies that could build incredible things, they say, can't be built today. Pure bull. The globalists all day want to suppress human ingenuity, human dynamic spirit, because it threatens them. Anthony, what's your take on the state of the world?
You know, it is time to join the party of reality, and it's time to join the new paradigm of reality, and it is infuriating because it seems the more crazy things are, the harder they are for people to believe. Just like Hillary Clinton doing all these things, it's almost like none of it matters at the end of the day because everyone's being drawn into her paradigm of debate. That's why Trump, and I don't want to get into Trump again, but
they try to control Trump, the debate.
Yes.
In their little crap house.
That's why Trump is so victorious. And that's why we are so victorious, because we won't.
That's what I did on CNN. That's why that one event, it's with Trump, it's like the CNN thing with Piers Morgan every single day, because he just gets off the script. He doesn't go in their paradigm. That's what we can learn from Trump.
It's like a coliseum. And that there's a huge coliseum, and in one corner there's a cage with a lion in it. And they say, come on, I'll fight you right in that cage. Come on in the cage, guys. It's totally fine. We'll fight in there. No, I'll fight in the rest of the coliseum and have fair ground. But if you fight them in their own manufactured paradigm, their politically correct, weird, fake paradigm where everything...
And that's why their paradigm gets weirder and weirder and crazier, and you can't say boy or girl, because they have to overturn reality in a freak show to beat us.
Because they want to make you look crazy if you're upset. Period. If you're upset.
And so we need to get upset. No, screw you. We are upset and it's normal.
Yep. It's true. Breaking out of the mold. It's almost like a physical mold around us. When we get angry, we get upset, we get passionate, we can do things. And the ultimate weapon of these people is to fight our passion. Even if it's just passion for your life or passion for painting, whatever it is.
They want us depressed and unhappy. No, I have passion. I'm a winner. I love it.
That's right. If you have passion, you can do anything. Period. I mean, that's why people gravitate to leaders. That's why people like this show. You obviously have tons of passion. That's why people on the debates with Trump and all these people, anyone that has passion, people want to follow, people want to listen.
They call it narcissism. And it's true. I'm narcissistic for humanity. I'm into winning. I'm a team player. I like people doing good.
You care more about an idea than yourself. And that's what you have passion for. And that's what people can see. And you have that because we're right over and over again. Just like you were talking about sodium fluoride, there was a study that cavities aren't even prevented by water fluoridation, period.
That's worse.
But now we're insane. We're, you know, conspiracy theories, but it's being proven over and over again. All this stuff is happening. You had Harry Dent and others on your show, and you were saying over and over again, China looks like it's going to collapse. You said it like 55 times. Ad nauseum, right?
6 months
ago. And now it's happening. And it's you're upset because you're impassioned because all of this is true and all this is
real. Because we're going to be in the middle of a total depression with armored vehicles rolling around and the bankers posing as the saviors. I can see it all.
And who cares who's right at that point? That's the issue. Who cares who is right? The point is the anger is not about being right. It's about wanting people to get impassioned about this and care about it now, even at the most fundamental basic levels. And I think it really comes down to a mental shift. And I think throughout history and all these subjects that we're going to talk about, one thing is true. It's called emotional leverage. When you care more about possible failure than the comfort of what you have right now, that's the only way we can make a change. When we get more...
Well, the Pentagon admits they can't take over a group that even has sticks and stones if the people believe they can't be defeated and never stop.
That's it.
That's why I say resistance is victory.
That's it.
That's an Alex Jones quote, because it is.
If you would rather succeed and endure that pain than fail, that is the only way we'll succeed. But people would rather be comfortable in their life and lose all their cash and get taxed to hell and get beaten by the
federal government. And pretend they're winning.
And pretend they're winning and be in their little fake artificial comfort zone.
America was great compared to other countries because people didn't want to be pushed around. Still some of that went on, but people would kill before they'd be slaves.
Yep, that's right. They had passion. They had ideology. They had fervor. They had everything they needed to do whatever they wanted. That's why we're the leaders in every single sector, every single industry. Now we don't have that. We've been desensitized mentally. We've been broken down, and we're sitting here.
The globalists knew what made us great, so everything they push is the opposite.
Why do you think so?
The nerve to attack men heading homes. That's how you decapitate a species.
I mean, just a small fragment of this. So in the 1950s and 1960s, we knew full well that gut health was the center of everything, and even the 40s and 30s. But for some reason, we forgot all about that. Everyone's on antibiotics. No one cares. And now everyone's getting mental illness. One in two people are going to be diagnosed, 50%.
That's because the gut makes the chemicals your brain operates on.
Of course. And guess what kills gut bacteria? Monsanto's Roundup, herbicides. McDonald's kills pretty much all of it.
Turns out Gates 30 years ago did all the research with his Microsoft money, and they're running the whole op.
Yeah.
I hate that bastard.
Yeah, the antibiotics and everything and the vaccination type compounds. So all of this is crushing you, and then it's making you mentally ill. And of course, then you're sitting there lobotomized, not knowing what to do. And it's all about awakening yourself. It's all about empowering yourself and having...
And it's these little mad scientists like sitting around how they screwed everybody over and how 1 in 25,000 had autism. Now it's 1 in 58. They're like, soon 1 in 3 and it's game over. Because that'll collapse society when 1 in 3 has to be taken care of.
Yeah.
I mean, they really know what they're doing, man. I got to tell you.
At the end of the day, you know, it's kind of an issue of we've let it come to this point. Now we have to decide we're not going to anymore, or it's just going to continue.
I want you to get into the new health news when we come back, but let's just briefly, we don't even need to plug it, but it helps fund the operation. The problem is it sells out so quick that we can't get it, so it doesn't really fund the operation. We got a bigger shipment coming in 2 weeks. BrainForce is back in. Tell folks briefly why its ingredients are so special, why it has such rave reviews at InfoWarsLife.com.
It's the new flagship InfoWarsLife.com product for a reason, because it has the natural compounds like Bacopa herb extract, Alpha GPC, has a number of ingredients that are actually considered prescription medication in Europe. But not to get into that, the key about BrainForce is it naturally activates your brain. It gives you sustainable, real energy. It powers you up. Personally, if you're going to sit there and you're going to let yourself be docile and be unhappy, that's your choice. I believe funding the operation is absolutely essential while getting awesome products like BrainForce. I helped develop it. The chemist.
This gives me the same feeling of after I've, you know, climbed a mile tall hill.
Yeah.
It helps me climb hills, too. I mean, it's just amazing. I've taken two of them today, and I'm going to stop now. But BrainForce, tell people briefly when we come back about some of the other ingredients in BrainForce. Then we'll get to the news you came in here about, and I'm not sorry I went wild. I'm waking up. I'm breaking my conditioning. I'm free. We're on the march. BrainForce will end up selling out, but then we're getting a big shipment in. This was just the first end of a large shipment. Is the laboratory couldn't make enough of it because some of the ingredients hadn't come in yet because they're so certified, so organic, so clean. We've got the testing, the certified studies, the links up on InfoWarsLife.com. And what's great about this is we can bring you the very best nutraceuticals out there at extremely affordable prices compared to major competitors, sometimes a third as much as leading competitors that aren't even as good. Get great reviews, create a huge base of customers that will fund building InfoWars into a larger, stronger media operation. I'll hire four or five more reporters, four or five more writers. I'll have people all over the world all the time reporting. We'll really take action. We'll start other shows. We'll start other TV and radio shows. I mean, if there's other folks better than I am, I'll put them on air. I mean, we want to take action here. And thanks to you, we're getting the word out. Supermel Vitality was sold out for 2 months. It's back in stock. At InfoWarsLife.com. No, this was sold out for 2 months. Supermel Vitality for like 3-4 weeks. It's all back at InfoWarsLife.com, and your purchase does fund the operation and hundreds of other great items at InfoWarsStore.com, from high-quality non-GMO seeds to shortwave radios to films and books and Patriot apparel, InfoWarsStore.com, and a subsection of it is InfoWarsLife.com. I want to hit some of these other stories here, Anthony, but before we go any further, mention some of the other ingredients that are in BrainForce.
Yeah, absolutely. So some of the ones I'm most excited about, yerba mate leaf powder. So I know you used to drink yerba mate pretty much every day. Now you just pop a BrainForce. It has the extract. It has the powder.
For whatever reason, it's better, though.
It is better. I rave about a lot of these products, but I'm taking BrainForce every single day. It is really powering me up. I mean, it is sustainable. It's not like an energy drink where you drink it and you kind of crash and you feel a little jittery and weird. This is, I would say it's a warm energy, if that makes sense. It's not, it doesn't freak you out. It
makes you confident.
Yeah, it does make you confident. Then we have the phosphatidylserine. This is the one that we had such an issue getting. So it is responsible for a lot of functions in the brain, but what it does is it works on cell structure. So this is why it was so hard to get. It used to be harvested. It had to be harvested from cow brains. Okay? This is how far people were willing
to. And you don't want to take a sponge of form and stuff off of it.
Right, obviously. So we can get it from cabbage now. That's what we're doing. But people were willing at one point in nutraceutical history to go into cow brains and extract this because of how strong it is.
And your brain's made up of it.
Yeah. It's essential for the cell structure. And then we have hyperzine A, and that's super... I believe it's my brain is working at 200 RPM right now. Think about it, because hyperzine A, I believe, is going to be turned into a pharmaceutical drug in the very, very near future. And I've already read numerous studies and articles on that because it's so powerful. I believe hyperzine A is one of the key components that actually blasts your brain into overdrive with this formula. But hyperzine A, we're looking at this because we're concerned we might have to take it out if it does become a drug, because then the FDA will have domain over it.
They already have in Europe, and they're saying they're trying. It could be within a year.
Yes. So that's why I'm concerned. That's why I'm stockpiling this, and I'm hoping we can get as much as we can before that may happen.
It's incredible that it's also hard to get this stuff.
It is.
That's why we're always having shortages. Believe me, I want to be able to just sell whatever we have.
It would be better to get more, that's for sure. But
then we could fund the operation, because it's like, oh, we sold out a month's worth in 2 days, but it's still the same as a month.
Yeah.
Because we can't get it. Right. So we don't get the money we need to fund the operation.
Yeah. And I mean, in the meetings that these, you know, you come in, you say, hey, when are we going to get this? And I feel bad having to say every single time, well, the manufacturer had to delay another 2 weeks, another 3 weeks, another month, whatever. Because we
And it's not just you. I've called around, you know, because there's only three of them that are, you know, the highest quality, trustworthy, and they're just backed up. But we're getting better. InfoWarsLife.com. Now, do five more minutes with us before I get the number out and cover economic, world, and military news that's huge in the third hour and take calls. Tell us what's coming up in the next 5 minutes.
We're going to talk about some of the countries that just banned GMO crops. Some that are looking at it. This new bill that would ban GMO labeling in the United States and what we can do about it.
So very exciting news. We're on the march. The empire is on the run. Walter Jones and others are moving to remove Boehner. That could be as big as the presidential election. That's why they never mention how powerful it is, because then folks would focus on their weak spot. Anthony Gucciardi's here with a lot of good news on health freedom front. Coming up, I'm going to play the video. It's up on InfoWars.com. This is interesting. Of an eagle knocking a drone out of the sky. But the most important issue is I'm going to give the phone number out and take your calls on the Chinese meltdown, the yuan being devalued. Is this fall, is this Christmas going to be the big one? Or another big global disaster they use to get more power. But Anthony, get into the news you were mentioning.
Right, so we've got some good news, and that is Scotland is to ban growing of genetically modified crops within its borders, and that's a big move. This is from Reuters. Scotland's devolved government said on Sunday it intended to ban the growing of genetically modified crops on its territory to protect its, quote, clean and green brand, and because there was little evidence that Scottish consumers wanted GMO products.
And that's the real green movement that they tie to global warming garbage that discredits it.
Right. And then you also have these fake green people that want GMOs, and they say they want GMOs, and they say it's for the farmers. And
that's like Monbiot, the big liberal environmentalist, that says he wants more nuclear reactors.
Right, right. But of course, we know every 30 minutes an Indian suicide happens because the farmers in India are killing themselves, oftentimes because of the fact that Monsanto puts them in debt and they can't feed their family. So they end up killing themselves. Thank you, Monsanto. You're an amazing corporation. But the bad news is, it's really good news, but it's bad news at the same time. We're beating Monsanto in such a degree that they're trying to push through this bill that many of you may have heard of. It's called the Dark Act. It's really called the safe and accurate food labeling bill.
The Monsanto protection.
Right. It's the Monsanto Protection Act on mega steroids, though, because it bans GMO labeling in the United States, period.
That way you cannot, as a company, say we're not GMO.
Oh, you can't as a state. So here's an example. Texas has a new bill that would label GMOs. This bill, the Dark Act.
And it's got bipartisan support. That shows how arrogant they are.
It's already passed the House.
I can't say this is non-GMO, our product.
We can't have mandatory GMO labeling. It's already passed the House, okay? And it is going to the Senate. It's called the Dark Act. We have some people speaking out against it. Gwyneth Paltrow just went to D.C. to talk about it. Here's a name from The Hill I'm talking about. Gwyneth Paltrow calls for GMO labeling. There's been a lot of people talking about this. The Dark Act would ban mandatory GMO labeling state levels in the United States.
Well, that bans free speech.
Oh, it bans everything. I mean, but the point is that Monsanto is losing so badly, they had to get this guy, Mike Pompeo, Representative Mike Pompeo, to go out and say, it's non-scientific to label GMOs. GMOs are perfectly safe. They feed people. Who cares if their Roundup is actually killing
them? Roundup's good for you. I'll drink a glass. Here, drink one. I don't know about to drink that.
Right, exactly.
Can they find that clip again, guys, where the guy that famously says he'll drink it, the spokesman for Monsanto, and you go, by the way, we do have Obama, since you mentioned, this is him and his campaign in 2007, saying that he would go for labeling. Here it is.
Country of origin labeling, because Americans should know where their food comes from. We'll let folks know whether their food has been genetically modified, because Americans should know what they're buying. We'll let folks know whether their food has been genetically modified, because Americans should know what they're buying.
There you go. And I've never seen a clip like that, where we get copyright claims and harassment, and so does everybody else, by a Democratic Party group that teamed up with them, with Obama, to make sure that clip is banned online.
I used it in a YouTube video and it got taken down.
Oh, yeah. Let's play it again, since they don't like it. Because guess what? This is my radio and TV show. This is not YouTube right now. And you want to sue me, go ahead and try. It's fair use. I'm going to play it again. Here it is.
Here's what I'll do as president. I'll immediately implement country of origin labeling, because Americans should know where their food comes from. We'll let folks know whether their food has been genetically modified, because Americans should know what they're buying. We'll let folks know whether their food has been genetically modified, because Americans should know what they're buying.
And now he works around the clock to stop that.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's the one who's going to have to sign off on this bill to ban GMO labeling. He's going to.
You have more, don't you? Or is that pretty much?
I have some more. I have some more. We can talk about it if you want.
All right. Well, let's do 5 more minutes. Then I promise I'm going to give the number out and we're going to go to your calls on the financial meltdown. Anthony Gucciardi's here. But this is some good news and some bad news because we know under TPP that it's been leaked that it just lets Monsanto ban GMO labeling worldwide and makes you take it in your country. I mean, come on. It's so totalitarian. But Bill Gates is involved, and he wants you to eat it because he loves you. It's not because he wants to hurt you. He's a nice man from Planned Parenthood. An example of how my weird brain works. There's video. There's a couple of these, but this is a new one. Of an eagle attacking a drone while it's filming. And it made me think about an article today about a robot that has babies. A robot that has a 3D printer. And then makes more of itself. So a drone's fancy, can do some incredible stuff, but can it lay eggs? Can it raise babies? Can it go out and live and get energy from the indigenous environment? And I guess as these new technologies develop, I guess it will be able to do that. So that's how my brain works whenever I see a story like this. But I tell you, can the drone take out an eagle? But I'm being racist against drones right now. Actually, folks, I'm all for drones. I just don't like the fact the globalists are deploying them and using them as tools of control against the general population. Coming up, this is out of London Telegraph, Russia and NATO actively preparing for war. Kurt Nimmo details it more with his article, NATO and Russia Prepare for War, on Infowars.com. Also, I'm going to look more at Legionnaires, the worst outbreak in history. Something serious is going on behind that. I've got a clip of Jeb Bush blaming Clinton and Obama for Iraq problems. They're all in the same club. It's all the very same policy. And then saying attack Assad to take out ISIS. Just incredible. Talked about that with Walter Jones earlier. It's now official. We talked about this when we were in Spain. The announcement was made. Now it's happened. First victim of Spain's gag law fined for criticizing lazy police. He said on Facebook they ought to have swimming pools and hammocks and palm trees at all their police stations. I will say the police look pretty lazy in Spain. But that's kind of how I want my police, you know? Not out writing tickets all day and responding to actual crime. Continuing... Japan's committed to nuclear power despite Fukushima fiasco. We're going to cover that. Scientists, I mentioned this, make a robot that can have babies. That ties in with a rise in brain-controlled robot armies, Daily Mail. Chinese military trained students to control machines with their minds. And another one, machine that turns poo into water gets test run in Africa. That's Wired Magazine. But, of course, what do you call Hillary Clinton? She's a machine that turns water into poo. I don't even know why I said that. Just trying to be simple. I don't even come up with this humor. It's why a lot of it isn't even funny. It's just stupid. But, I mean, she takes information that's real and then puts out. Yeah, I mean, she exports like raw sewage. Instead of projectile vomit, she just opens her mouth and sprays out. Every stenching, you know, they say hell stinks, and I'm told Hillary Clinton smells like a dead dog from about 100 yards away.
Her GDP is very high in excrement.
Exactly. But if you go up to Infowars.com, we've got some more serious articles up there on that front. But getting serious here before we finish up with your articles, Anthony, I want to hear from you, the listeners, in the rest of the hour after the break, on how big a deal is this, the currency war, China devaluing its currency like 4 points or almost 4 points the last 2 days, what that's doing to commodities, gold and silver's up, but other commodities are down. How do you have a fiat printing press that's on high that normally causes inflation or hyperinflation, but then you have depressionary manipulations as well? I call it hyperstagflation. But overall, it's just depressionary at this point, because the globalists only give the free money and only give the inflation money to themselves. That's what a managed economy can do. The ultimate screw job. So here are the headlines. China could trigger the biggest financial rout since 2008. 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash is becoming even more likely. I'm going to cover that after Anthony leaves. China currency devaluation could spark tidal wave of deflation, London Guardian, Financial Times of London, what next, a Chinese housing crash, China currency devaluation sends global exports reeling. We'll give you the latest on the markets right now after break as well. Gold and silver surges, dollar dumps. But Anthony, finishing up with the health news that you had.
Right, so last segment we were talking about this new bill, which is called the DARK Act. That's what it's nicknamed. Its true name is the Safe and Accurate Food Labeling Bill. And what it would do is it would ban mandatory labeling inside the United States at a state level. So that means if Texas, for example, were to introduce a labeling bill, which it has done, and it were to pass, this bill would co-opt that and it would crush it and it would shut it down. And the DARK Act, I think, is the biggest threat we face to our food intelligence in decades, because we would no longer have the ability to know what we're eating under law. But at the same time,
why are you being racist against GMO?
Well, I am being racist.
These are new creatures they've created. You should just eat it and shut up.
They deserve human rights.
Be diverse.
Yeah, exactly.
I have a huge brain tumor.
Yeah, destroy your DNA and just die. It's not a big deal. But at the same time, it shows that Monsanto's losing the fight, because they have to go as far as to ban our ability to know what we're eating in order for us to, you know, for them to survive, really. And also ties into this article, Monsanto sets off corporate feeding frenzy, because what they're doing is they're losing so much money. Last quarter, they lost, it was $128 million, I believe, last fourth quarter. And they are trying to buy Syngenta, which is kind of like an experimental GMO biotech company that's even weirder and even more potentially insane than Monsanto. But Syngenta's not going for it. So they're starting this attempt to have a forced buyout of Syngenta for X amount of cash. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to corner the market so that they can survive and they can keep manipulating everything. And Syngenta has even gone as far. This is a company that's looked into biopharmaceutical crops, growing vaccines out of crops.
It's already going on everywhere. Yeah.
So they're talking about, you know, sterilizations through these crops, all this insane stuff. Monsanto's trying to buy these people out so the next generation of biotech will come through, and at the same time shutting down our ability to know. So if we actually can fight the DARK Act, it'll be a major victory. But if the DARK Act goes through and Monsanto and Obama signs off on it, if it passes the Senate, the same guy in 2007 who said he would ban GMO labeling, it will be a massive victory for Monsanto and a major defeat for humanity.
And even if they win on that front, it'll just cause folks to start their own black market labeling, and it'll just push people to the farmers' markets more.
Right, right. And to be clear, corporations, it's technically illegal for corporations to label non-GMO right now, actually, through the FDA and USDA laws.
Remember Horizon Milk like 6, 7, 8 years ago? They got sued by the synthetic bovine growth hormone maker because they just said, we don't have any growth hormone.
Yeah, RBGH, yeah.
And they sued him. You can't say you don't have it.
Now you have to say not that there's anything different. And the DARK Act, to be clear, would ban mandatory GMO labeling at a statewide level. So we can still say things are non-GMO if a corporation chooses to do that. But then that's also technically legal too, and Monsanto can go after you for that. It's totally insane.
They don't want us passing laws that we can have labels.
Yeah, there's a reason 96% of shareholders of Monsanto would vote against GMO labeling.
And there's a reason CNBC and Associated Press and others and the Canadian broadcasting system as well have all reported for 15 years, or 17 years, since 99, that Monsanto, at all their major facilities, has non-GMO cafeterias for their scientists.
Of course. Of course they do, right? Just like, you talk to somebody in one of
because it's the next level of Planned Parenthood. They're eugenicist. They're stacking traits in for social control.
And they laugh when these fake scientists defend them. All the top scientists say one thing: we don't know what's going to actually happen. We have no idea. And that's even more scary to me than saying, well, it could cause a little bit increase in cancer. You know, we know that
Roundup. Yeah, but in the case of Roundup and these plants bioaccumulating, and it grows tumors. They admit that.
Oh, yeah, it does. The World Health Organization confirmed that. Now we need a massive ban. Countries are banning it. Just the Roundup alone. But in terms of the next generation of GMO crops, what they're going to do for, you know, 20, 40, 30 years from now, top scientists, the most concerning part to me is not even that they say, yeah, it'll probably cause cancer. They say, we don't even know what it'll do to us.
All right, Anthony, thank you so much. I know you'll be covering more of this at Infowars.com and, of course, NaturalSociety.com and, of course, StoryLeague.com.
Thank you.
There goes Anthony Gucciardi. All right, here's the toll-free number on the economic front. I want to hear your take. Is this the big one coming up this fall, this winter? I mean, we're already in a global depression worldwide. There's civil wars all over the place. There's wars on the border with Russia, China. The financial collapse did start 2 years ago. It never really ended. The recession never really ended, most economists agree. But it's definitely getting worse now worldwide. And so Gerald Celente was right when he said 4 years ago, within 2 years, you'll see a global meltdown. It's just the media is so good at papering things over that for people in the West or those that aren't doing really bad, they're like, oh, everything's great. Well, no, it's not. We're living on debt. We're living on the very tail end of this. We're sitting on top of the biggest debt bubbles ever. We know what happened in Weimar Republic and Zimbabwe and Chile and everywhere else and here before. So what's your view on how serious the situation is and where you see it going next? I hope Ron Paul and many others we have on are wrong, but I've never heard Ron Paul in 20 years of interviewing him, 20 years, say, I think reckoning is just about to happen. And it's just, I feel it in my gut. The elites are headed to their bunkers. Governments are buying armored vehicles. There's a digging in. Soros wants to stir up a civil war in the middle of all this. He just took down Ukraine. He isn't playing games, folks. I mean, you see everything coming together. The stars are aligning and not in a good way. So my pucker factor is at about a 9 right now. And Spidey sense is off the chart. So I hope folks are getting ready. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you're not feeling it. Maybe you're not seeing it. Please tell me I'm wrong. 800-259-9231. 1-800-259-9231. And if you just tuned in for the first time on one of our wonderful AM/FM affiliates, you're listening to The Alex Jones Show. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're a multimedia, liberty-based, truth-based organization in Austin, Texas, with reporters and writers and investigative journalists and researchers, an incredible crew and engineers and folks behind the scenes that bring you an unabashed, hardcore, freedom-promoting organization that will not back down. Please support our local AM/FM affiliates today. Become a sponsor. Spread the word about the show. Or support those local sponsors and let them know why you are. Or buy the station a billboard. If people with means don't take action in the fight for liberty, we're going to lose everything. The public mind is ready to be awakened. You got to be the cold water in the bucket to be splashed on them. I told the story. I wrote Willie Nelson a note when he came to one of my movie showings like 8-9 years ago. They said, you know, Willie Nelson's in the back. I said, yeah, whatever. Gave a speech. At the end, I was signing DVDs and Willie Nelson came behind and shook my hand. I'm not name dropping. It's just a funny story. And he went over and was doing some other stuff because the Alamo Drafthouse was selling other movies and stuff in a store. And I said, real fast, and I wrote out deadlines and commitments, what to keep in, what to keep out, you know, traveling miles a minute for months at a time. And I kind of wrote it out, gave him my phone number, my cell phone. I'd leave with the radio producer. And then months later, ring, it's Willie Nelson on the phone. And he's like, against the wind. Well, I'm pretty busy, but I like the fact you brought that up, so I'll come on your show. And it just shows how if nothing ventured, nothing gained. Just an interesting little story. Every time I hear that song with the Highwaymen singing it, I'm procrastinating. I really don't want to get into this financial news. It's bad. Real bad. And in the next segment, I'm going to give you the latest from Bloomberg, CNBC, and others on what's happening in markets since this morning. But the big picture, if you just joined us, is the situation with the 12 signs that an imminent global financial crash has become even more likely. Then we're going to come back and go to Morgan, Chris, Dan, Sherry, Bob, and others. But while we're busy focused on Megyn Kelly dirty talking on Howard Stern, while we're busy, you know, looking at what Donald Trump's doing in the latest diversion, the New World Order is on the move. Michael Snyder article up on Infowars.com going over the signs that things are serious. The evaluation of the yawn took virtually the entire planet by surprise and not in a good way. Actually, we've been talking a lot about the plan. They dropped their currency. Didn't take us by surprise. I mean, it's just a fact, just a fact. Number two, one of the big reasons why China devalued the yuan was to try to boost exports. Yeah, their economy's collapsing. China's exports declined 8.3% in July, and global trade overall is falling at a pace that we haven't seen since the last recession because taxes are too high, not because interest rates are too low. Now that the Chinese have devalued their currency, other nations will rely on the exports and indicating that they might do the same thing. That's a currency war, a race to the bottom, which is led by the U.S. that's been devaluing the dollar. They're just following suit. If you scan the big financial news sites, it seems like there's a term currency war is now being bandied about quite a bit. No, it's a concerted global devaluation. This is the very first time the 50-day moving average for the Dow has moved below the 200-day moving average in the last 4 years. This is known as the death cross. The world enters the death cross and is a very troubling sign. We are just about to the point where all of the most common technical signals that investors typically use to make investments decisions will be the screaming sell and running for the exit like a chicken with their head lopped off. And, of course, when they sell, 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 that's when you buy, buy, buy. The price of oil just closed at a brand-new six-year low. When the price of oil started to decline back in the late 2014, a whole lot of people were proclaiming that this would be a good time for the U.S. economy. Now we can see just how wrong they were. At this point, the price of oil has already fallen to a level that is going to be absolutely nightmarish for the global economy if it stays there. Just a consideration what Jeff Gulak had to say about it in December. And back in December 2014, Bond King had a serious warning for the world if oil prices got to $40 a barrel. I hope it does not go to 40, he said in a statement, because then something is very, very wrong with the world, not just the economy, but the geopolitical consequences could be, to put it bluntly, terrifying. And yeah, it's not good to have oil at 150, but below about 90, you can't really explore for it anymore, unless you're the Saudis that have it already on tap. Helps them, bankrupts their competition, bankrupts Russia, puts pressure on China. And people go, good, that's our competition. No, it's not. They globalized us, so when somebody goes in the toilet, we go in it. Number six, this week we learned that OPEC has been pumping more oil than we thought, and it's been projected that this could cause the price of oil to plunge into the 30s. Number 7, number 8, number 9, number 10, number 11, number 12, when we come back and then to your phone calls. I'm Alex Jones. I'm not happy that we're being proven right in spades. Not happy at all. But to my detractors, everybody that hates me, I knew I'd be right, so suck an egg, punks. The story's up on Infowars.com, and it just ties into the hypocrisy, and I'm going to go to your phone calls. Donald Trump sexist, Megyn Kelly talks dirty with Howard Stern. And we've got Hillary Clinton salivating over her, going, what an amazing woman she is. Past behavior demonstrates Kelly's nonchalantness with sexual issues. So Hillary and her are acting like if somebody talks about blood coming out of someone, oh, my gosh, you men are so horrible. And Bernie Sanders says, I think any criticism of Hillary is sexist. I love the Soviet Union. It was so good. And then Kurt's got the quotes. The 10-minute video is up on Infowars.com. Maybe we'll play some of it tomorrow. I mean, I've been on Howard Stern's show a few times. That's his venue. It's interesting. I'm not attacking Howard Stern himself. It's just the hypocrisy of her going on talking about a bunch of sex and stuff, and nobody's saying, oh, my gosh, it's so sexist that men talk about sex in front of women. So you want to have it both ways. Hillary Clinton tweeted, what a lot of men on that stage had to say in the debate was offensive. You know, we find you, Hillary, offensive, leaving folks to die in Benghazi and all the rest of the criminal activities you're involved in. Carly Fiornia tells Face the Nation, women were horrified by Megyn Kelly's comments. See, it's all about vote for Hillary. Trump banned from Republican event over sexist comments, the CBC says. That's great. Ban people now over their speech. Yes, it's so liberal. That's up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com right now. It needs to get out there. Meanwhile, China could trigger the biggest financial rout since 2008. That's already happening. Russia and NATO actively preparing for war. London Telegraph, rival war games by Russia, armed forces, and NATO represent greatest buildup of military tension in Europe since the Cold War, warns think tank. We've been telling you that forever. Just pointing out again, we don't make stuff up. The world is accelerating into insanity. Obama said, remember, a few months ago, again, he said it last year too, the world's been never more stable since his administration. As if he runs anything. That's a lie that he stabilized the world. It's a lie he runs things. The people that run Boehner and run him, they run things. Like Congressman Jones said earlier, Congress is a bunch of puppets now, and people are tired of it. Let's go to some phone calls here. Let's talk to Morgan in Washington, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Great show, Alex. This is a really complex issue, this currency thing, but I would like to juxtapose two events that are happening at the same time. One everybody is looking at. The other event, no one's paying attention to. We know what China does. They devalue their currency, and this is in an effort to gain a trade advantage. They've beat us up like this for years now. But something else that has kind of slipped off the page, and if you'll look at the New York Times yesterday afternoon, they had a story there that says that the Iraqi parliament has unanimously passed Prime Minister Abadi's groundbreaking and far-reaching reforms. I've been following Iraq pretty close. They're not the jumbled ball of wire that people think they are. This Abadi is a sharp cookie. He's pulling that country together, and this big package of laws they passed yesterday are very vital and will coincide with the laws that they're going to pass tomorrow, which will be another groundbreaking event. These all have to do with Iraq rejoining the global economic community. Now, with that being said, let's bounce back to China. They have been, and is well known, hoarding gold like crazy for quite some time now, and we know that they've been petitioning the IMF, Christine Lagarde, because they want to take the position of the world's global currency, the reserve currency, and they've got enough gold, it is suspected at this point, to back that with gold. So
yeah, they've been talking about a global SDR, 10 to 30% backed by a basket of commodities, chief among them gold. And that's why they're maneuvering this collapse to then have another round of too big to fail, you know, quadrillions of taxpayer money, and then tell us we're in debt to them because we bailed them out. But they're moving towards the next step of just getting rid of the entire system.
Well, and that's kind of where I'm going, because I think that what China is doing is that I know you agree that these backroom deals are made constantly. But what they're doing is they're purposely torpedoing the fiat currency systems that are out there. And bear in mind, not only is the dinar at the value of 1,166 dinar to the dollar, but the rupiah is also positioned to revalue. And Christine Lagarde says she's got 204 people on board for a global currency reset. Now, these things are all happening way too close.
That's right. Together. They're devaluing them to cheat the system, to consolidate power while giving themselves free money. And then when they're done and have maxed it out as much as they can, they're going to burn down the business and collect the insurance money that's the banker bailout, and then start getting us ready for the new solution to fix things. Just like the euro implodes countries, the answer is get rid of any sovereignty you had left and give it to them. Their answer is technocracy, which is a technologically based dictatorship.
Well, this basket of currencies is going to include the U.S. dollar, but it's going to be a devalued dollar, probably by as much as 30%, and then you're going to see the reinstatement of the old currency in Iraq, the dinar, at the same time is going to go probably back to $3.22 to the dinar like it was before they were put under bankruptcy by the United Nations. And see, this ground is fertile. This is ripe for this global currency reset, which has been Christine Lagarde's wet dream ever since she got in office.
Well, that's always been the Trilateral Commission plan since the 70s, but God bless you. I appreciate your call. Here's what I know. There are a whole bunch of global crises that have been exacerbated, accentuated, and manufactured in some cases. The globals didn't do it all, but most of it. They're riding that horse. And strap yourselves in. We're in for a very interesting time. In fact, I didn't finish the last points on this article. Then I'll go to your calls. Six, this week we learned that OPEC has been pumping more oil, and they're talking about it going to $30 a barrel. Seven, in recent article explained the collapse in the commodity prices that we are witnessing right now is eerily similar to what we witnessed just before the stock market crash of 08. On Tuesday, things got even worse for commodities as the price of copper closed at a brand new six-year low. The South American debtors, number eight, crisis of 2015 continues to intensify. Brazil's government bonds have been downgraded to just one level above junk status. The approval rating of Brazil's president has fallen into the single digits. Number nine, just before the financial crisis of 08, a surging U.S. dollar put the extraordinary amount of stress on emerging markets. Now that this is happening again, emerging market stocks just hit a brand new four-year low on Tuesday thanks to a stunt that China just pulled. Number 10, things are not so great in the United States either. The ratio of household inventories to sales in the United States just hit the highest level since last recession. What this means is there are a whole lot of stuff sitting in warehouses out there that is just waiting to be sold in an economy that is rapidly slowing down. Number 11, speaking of slowing down, the growing of consumer spending in the United States has just plummeted to multi-year lows. Deep inside, most of us can feel what is coming. According to Gallup, the number of Americans that believe the economy is getting worse is almost 50% higher than the number of Americans that believe the economy is getting better. Things are lining up perfectly for a global financial crisis and a major recession beginning in the fall of winter of 2015. But just because things look like they will be happening a certain way does not necessarily mean they will. All it takes is a single event or some sort of change for things to really shift quickly. So what do you believe will happen in the months ahead? And that's what I'm asking the listeners as well. So let's go on to Sherry in Texas. Thanks for holding.
Hi, Alex. Thank you. Yeah, I agree. I think, you know, what goes up like a rocket comes down like a rocket. This is what's always happened to me with the stocks. I'm out of stocks now. All I have is some silver iShares. That's it. And it's a cash account. And here's why I put myself in that position, because whenever something like this comes up, they always run it up so the rich can, you know, pull in their bucks. And then it just goes down like a rocket. And so my investment brokerage, I've moved out of my money fund because it was, it has an asset value. It works like an investment, and it has a dollar per share value. Now, if that could go down while we sleep, you understand, and we could wake up and it's 30, like the guy's saying, 30% less or something, and our money fund would shrink in our account. So I moved it. Now, this works well for me because a cash account can have up to $250,000 max, and that's going to be good enough for me for my brokerage. And then they have some other options, but they involve moving your money around, and I don't know how viable that's going to be if we're going to be digitally attacked all the time. But anyway, now about the war, about politicians, I think the war is, and I agree with those who say this, that the war is going to give way to earth changes, and soldiers will leave the battlefield and they want to be there for their families. So I don't know how successful a war is going to be. Also, there's other things that we have to consider that is only talked about on certain shows, about rockets being intercepted, you know, and interdimensional.
I mean, there's all sorts of bizarre stuff that happens in the world. All I know is there's an engineered global financial meltdown clearly on the horizon. The question is it 100 miles away or a mile away? God bless you. I appreciate your call. Let's go ahead and talk to Bob in Nevada. You're on the air.
Thank you, Alex, for taking my call. I really appreciate what you're doing. And you've done it so well that when I see things popping on the news, et cetera, I know how to think. I know what it really is. And then a little while later, you break the news, and then even the major media break it. So couldn't agree with you more about all that's happening. What I want to talk about is two quick solutions. Well, not so quick. The first is, of a fashion, we're different than Iceland, but they threw out the bombs, threw out the Federal Reserve, threw out the Planned Parenthood funding, along with the IRS, the CIA, threw out the UN, a serious restart. And
absolutely. And it turned out 93% of Iceland's debt was not their debt. It was foreign banker debt that their criminal government signed on to. So they arrested, indicted, and convicted their ministers that were involved. And notice, that was not even in the news. I mean, that was only in their newspapers.
I would love for you to really jump all over that and get something going. Of course, everything that you've done so far puts your life in great jeopardy. This would just about, you might have to kiss everybody goodbye before you started it.
Well, the good news is there's so many people know what's going on now. It's not as dangerous as it used to be telling the truth. I mean, they admit world government. They wanted to get all this built and then deny it, but now they haven't quite completed it, and it's been admitted to. So in a way, I'm kind of passe. That's what scares me, though, is this stuff is so far along. My show's not that radical anymore. What does that mean? It means that we failed to stop it. But we enter that paradox where now things are getting so real that maybe we can get people awake. What do you think?
I think I hope and pray you're right. And that with that little transition word, about a year ago, you had a pastor on. I think 2 Chronicles 7:14. If you could have a regular thing every week or 1 hour or sometime where we just turn to God, because I think that's the fail safe of how we're going to get this turned around. I know you're a believer.
I wish the churches would turn to God. No, I hear you. I go to these mainline churches. It's like hearing Baphomet give a speech. Everything's fine. Go to sleep. Everything's wonderful. I hear you, Bob. Great points. I want to go to Chris and others that are patiently holding in just a moment. Briefly, speaking of funding this operation, we were sold out for a while. Super Male Vitality doesn't artificially raise your testosterone or other hormones. It just gets your glands going, according to the research we've done and Dr. Group that designed it. All I know is it works really great and has known concentrated organic herbs. The key is the concentration. That's why it's so strong. Super Male Vitality is back after being sold out for weeks. Super Male Vitality is back in stock at InfoWarsLife.com. We are now taking orders on this new emergency shipment. Super Male Vitality has hundreds of five-star reviews at InfoWarsLife.com and is our best-selling formula for a reason. It really works. Let's just read some of these latest reviews from InfoWarsLife.com about our certified third-party review system. And again, get your Super Male Vitality now while supplies last at InfoWarsLife.com. And here's just a few of them. This is from Gary. Oh, actually, I have the reviews here in my hand for the Brain Force got mixed in with the reviews that I had.
We've got some on screen
for Super Male Vitality. I got three folders here and just don't have the reviews for Super Male Vitality here in my stack. Maybe somebody can print me some and then do it, because I don't know if I can read from 15 feet away off that computer screen, but TV viewers can. Great product, tasty. I worked a night shift from 11:30 to 7 a.m. Let me tell you, I am up all night long doing great work, which I never... I just can't read it. You moved it. All right. Anyways, the point is that the reviews are supposed to be in my folder, and they're not there. Now, we're going to go ahead and go back to your phone calls now. Let's go ahead and talk to Chris in South Carolina. Chris, you're on the air.
Yes, sir. I had recollection as I was studying history, looking at like the Civil War, and actually truthfully what went on when it really came down to it, it was nothing about slaves. Both North and South had slaves.
Oh, whatever. The public just wants to dig up Confederate generals while foreign governments put brain poison in the water. So let them. They all want to just be slaves and run over and wear different colored socks and have mustaches. Go ahead.
But what I'm saying is, I'm thinking what they're trying to do is use the same angles that they did when they started that war to start this war. And if you think about Jade Helm, it all plays in at the same time. And like that guy was talking about with China, don't we honestly owe China all this money and all anyway? Like, isn't most of our...
China is the second largest owner of our national debt. Something like $2 trillion worth. The Federal Reserve, the private Federal Reserve, is the largest owner. China a few years ago was the biggest, but now the government, basically through the Federal Reserve, buys most of its debt. So there's just a giant total fiat race to the moon going on right now. And so who knows when it's going to collapse or go down, my friend. But listen, the Pope's coming to the U.S. And he's going to speak from Lincoln's Gettysburg lectern. And the Vatican said to send the message that Lincoln sent. So, yeah, what's a foreign leader of a sovereign state doing lecturing Congress and speaking from the dictator Lincoln's lectern? And you can say what you want about Abraham Lincoln, whether he was good or bad. He was a dictator. I mean, he was arresting Congress. Hundreds of newspaper editors were arrested. He suspended habeas corpus and did a bunch of other stuff. And it's just, who would have ever known we'd have a pope here lecturing us? I mean, it just becomes fruitcake land.
I agree with that totally. And I agree that the same group that the pope is with was the same group that Lincoln was a part of. And if you get back into your history of that, for viewers that go into that, it kind of makes sense why he's going with the Lincoln point of view, because Lincoln was the one that caused, if I'm not mistaken, the South to take on public education.
Well, yeah, they came in and federalized everything in Reconstruction. I appreciate your call and looted it. And again, the Civil War was a tragedy. Both sides were manipulated. It's just, it's all chumpville. I mean, people were a lot more informed then, but they were still chumped big time. And we'll be chumped again. I mean, people like to be chumped. They like to be run over by the New World Order. Most people that are awake don't. But the giant mass of people out there, I just can't believe how stupid they are. I mean, I go out and talk to people, and people are either really informed and really awake and really smart and really cool of every race, color, and creed, or they're really stupid and lethargic and mindless and slow, and they love it and they enjoy it and they're proud of it and they're going to keep doing it basically forever. And that's why we're not a democracy. Because in a democracy, you could have 51% of people vote to make the other 49% slaves, or to raise their taxes, or to take their property. And in a republic, you can't take my children, you can't take my guns, you can't do things even if you vote for it. We can vote on general issues, but you can't vote on the Bill of Rights. You can't overturn that of the Constitution. And that's why it's a big deal when they start doing that and teach school kids that we're a democracy over and over and over and over and over again. Because in ancient Greece, in the city-states that had democracy, they would vote by black and white stones. And a black stone was a no vote, a white stone was a yes vote. And they'd get together and say, we don't like this guy. We don't like how he looks. We want to kill him. They'd have an absolute democracy vote. And if they voted with more white stones than black stones, they'd kill you. I mean, I don't want to live in a country like that, where you got this big howling mob of people, that can't find their butt with both hands, and then they're going to tell me how I'm supposed to run my life. I mean, these Bernie Sanders morons, 70,000 have come out just in 3 days to hear him at three different events in California. And he's promising them all these free goodies and less work days and more pensions and more freebies. I mean, California, the average pension is something like $200,000 a year. Some city managers, are getting like $800,000 a year. I mean, it's just crazy town. You can't do that forever. And I'm against that welfare, corporate welfare, government welfare, but also even for the low individual who needs it, because it's about a domestication process and it's always used long term to totally take over the society. That's why they want to make people sick. It's why they want to dumb people down. Is because it's easy to break things and be evil. It's easy to cheat. It's easy to steal. It's easy to be lazy. It's easy to lie on the surface when you're living in a prosperous economy. But when everybody starts cheating and stealing, finally things collapse. Amanda in Indiana, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi. I was trying to call in the last 2 days. 2 days ago, you were talking about Trump and his campaign, if you want to call it that. I just wanted to make a really quick point, actually 2 points. Number one, we live in an age where you have to tread through the fire of lies just to find where the truth is at. And then on top of that, you live in an age also where in the 1920s, they invented the television. By the 1940s, pretty much everybody had a television. And now we're in 2015 and everybody's controlled by a television. If you watched the GOP debates the other night, it was absolutely insane, because it all to me looked just like a reality television show. It looked like you were watching the Kardashians. there you had Trump center stage. You know, he was just ready to lead out the party, and Americans loved it. They had more American viewers than they've ever had for the GOP debates, especially the Republican Party. More people have actually said that they're going to watch them in the future. It really doesn't matter, I don't think. I don't think it matters if Clinton wins. I don't think it matters if Trump wins. I think they know that whichever one wins, they have control of. We don't have control. Our country has no control over anything.
No, I hear you, ma'am, and I appreciate your call. But it don't feel down, because it's that realization that's going to end up saving us. A little bit of overdrive here and take some final calls on the internet only. Well, some stations carry the next hour, but we're about to start doing the whole fourth hour live again with the roundtable discussions and more here in just the next few months. We'll be announcing that soon. I did get the reviews here. Here's a few of the latest reviews on Super Male Vitality. I'm 54 and have been working out most of my life. Recently, the weights in the gym started to feel heavier, and I was waking up tired in the morning. I was not feeling like I should, considered I live in a very healthy lifestyle, so I decided to try this product. I am so glad I did. My workouts at the gym are the way they were 6 or 7 years ago. I'm using heavier weights and doing more total sets and not feeling wiped out. After doing so, I'm waking up feeling rested and am not tired. This stuff really works. Thank you so much. I've been using this along with Survival Shield X2 for 2 weeks and feel great. Lowering the price a little would encourage more people to buy, in my opinion. Thanks again, InfoWars. Yeah, it's one of the more expensive products. Leading competitors double that or even more because it costs so much to get it and then it's concentrated. But we are looking at a pill form where it would be just as strong and maybe half the price. So I'm on that right now. We'll be right back, InfoWarsLife.com. You tune into any Grammy or Emmy Award show, you tune into music awards, it's always some weird satanic stuff, the NFL halftime, Super Bowl. Bizarre images of Satan appear on Empire State Building. Christians and conspiracy theorists freak out over demonic ceremony. And, man, the video is bizarre. And it's definitely Baphomet, all-seeing eye, demons dancing all over the building. You can actually document cam in there on the wall here, and I'll show folks. There you go. But that's up on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. We'll obviously be covering that more on the nightly news this evening. But it is very, very strange. You know, I get bummed out talking about the world economy being engineered to melt down. I get a little bit grumpy sometimes when I'm covering it, but we've really got to try to pull out of all this. And if the globalists know that the public knows that they're engineering it, they'll back off. But there's such financial and political ignorance, they get away with it. The people perish for lack of knowledge. Charles in Georgia, thanks for calling. You're on the air.
Hey, how are you doing, sir? Good to be back on the show again. I want to start off by thanking your audience for the love and support that they showed us on our YouTube channel, Nation of Truth. And I called in last week, and Mr. Jim Mars was on the show, and David Knight. By the way, David Knight is doing a traveler's job, and you need to give him a bonus. Tell him Charles said so. But, I want to talk a little bit about the whole Oath Keepers thing, how they tried to set you up. My gut tells me that later this year, they're going to try to set you up, and I've been praying for you. I said, I got to call Mr. Alex Jones today again. And what I think is they're going to try to do something dramatic to try to blame you for it so they can use the federal government to come in and try to take you out. Folks, we got to get behind Mr. Alex Jones, and we got to pray for him because and his family, because I think they hate the truth so much, these tyrants do and these authoritarians do, that they're going to try to go to any extent to try to set up Mr. Alex Jones and try to take him out. And, you know, in the 1700s and 1800s, I know I wasn't born back in that time, but if we had been back in that time, Mr. Alex Jones would have been considered as a general. I know he's not a military person, but he would have been considered as a general because of his ability to lead people and influence people as well. And you all, Alex Jones, you got to be very grateful for the audience that you got. I know I certainly am, for all the love and support that your audience showed me on our YouTube channel at the Nation of Truth on YouTube. And
well, I'm familiar with your channel, and look, I am humbled. I never intended to be a major leader in this fight, but I've stepped up just because I couldn't help myself. It's so outrageous what's happening, but you're absolutely right. When they had thousands of articles and hundreds of local newscasts dozens of national newscasts conservatively, and probably a dozen times on MSNBC alone, saying that I said imminent martial law would happen by August 15th. Everybody would be arrested, you know, gun confiscation. Never said any of that. Said the government's preparing for that. Jade Helms conditioning. That was an attempt to assassinate my character. And then every time they keep trying to connect me to guns and connect me to violence and connect me to some incident, because, yes, we're major league on the radar screen. And the good news is most people, even in law enforcement, are not bad folks. So that's why the globalists have trouble setting people up. If they can find something you've done to make it look like it's criminal, you know, a check you bounce or a political donation you give. I mean, I've given money to Ron Paul before, like $2,000. It becomes a national story. They try to act like it was illegal. I mean, just whatever it is, we got to know what's happening. It's the price we pay to stand up for the unborn and others. But yes, clearly they are more deceptive than ever. Clearly in the talking points, it's in the memos, go after us. And so that's what's happened. And it's why I got backup reporters. I got David Knight, whatever. They try to throw me in prison. I have a full intention to try to continue on with InfoWars, whether they kill me or whatever. But I hear you. I need your prayers. Sorry to Taylor, Chris, David, Tim, and others. We're out of time. Thank you, Charles, for that call. Nightly news is tonight, 7 o'clock Central. But I think what you're getting at is don't take this show for granted. Because for all its problems, I think it's some of the best stuff.